What day is it? What day is it?
Come on, come on.
Tell me what day it is.
It's Friday. Friday, baby. Oh, we made it, man. We made it through a shortened week. We made it through the weeks that's felt the longest ever for those who have had to work through it. But we are here together. That's the most important thing. Good morning, Sunshine.
Good morning. How are you doing, lad? Oh, it's so good to see Graham on a long weekend. Well, the thing is, it could have been a long weekend. If you took leave today, then well done to you. You've made it an extended weekend. Congratulations. If you're going to work today, then it's okay, man. It's fine.
It's all right. We will underpin the importance of the day today, and hopefully there are some people doing the most, because it is World Water Day. Hasn't that just hit a pressure point? We know how vitally important it is here in South Africa, but globally it becomes a massive, massive effort. And we're going to share initiatives that break records and put the spotlight on one of our most valuable natural resources that needs to be conserved. I think we take it for granted.
Yeah, we do. And I wish that Tyler was involved in World Water Day. That would be lovely. But it's fine. Check's probably in the mail. But then former Miss SA is here. Dr. Tamron Green Khumalo is here today sharing her struggle with having tuberculosis on World TB Day and putting an end to the stigma around the infectious disease and adding some facts that you need to know. I think that's going to be great. And an amazing ambassador.
And data sharing is our superpower.
Yes,
right
it
now.
Is.
We've got to share the information. Then, of course, we're going to hop back into the kitchen and be inspired. We've got this long weekend. We've got the Easter weekend coming up. And Chef Clem is going to whip up a curried leg of lamb and creamy mushroom barley recipe.
Indeed.
These things come to him in crazy dreams.
Yes.
And then I think you've got a little bit of
I do have something. So the thing is, it was just a random thing on set. I said, like, you know what you should do?
Oh.
And then they said, let's make it a recipe.
Oh.
So it's great. It came from here. It is a Mellows recipe, which is fantastic. So I guarantee you, it's going to give you a massive surprise.
I think I ate a whole box of Mellows yesterday.
Did you?
Okay.
Me too.
And it's not even the Easter weekend yet. And of course, finally, entertaining us is none other than the legend of Soki. It's Dozy himself. He is a legend. He's ripped. He's ready to rock. He looks like he's in the shape of his life at the moment, but the energy is just next level, man. And he's about to celebrate a massive milestone in his life. So we cannot wait to connect with him. And of course, connect with our girl, Zanele. A very good morning. She doesn't look like she partied at all this week for her birthday.
Good morning, family. I feel like you guys are the ones who didn't party. You got so much energy and you're giving it to me here in Johannesburg, and I love it. Hello, South Africa, and a very big welcome to your Feel Good Breakfast show. Of course, you know we're coming to you live from the Samsung showroom at Design Quarter in Johannesburg. And today, you heard that delicious, delicious menu that we've got on the way. However, we also want to hear from you on social media as well as with those voice notes, that lovely morning voice of yours. You got to come through. I am talking about the fact that we are within our Good Morning post. It is already out and you just need to go and get involved. Hashtag Expresso Show and the number that you use, 063-408-8863. We want to know, on World Water Day, H2O baby, we want to hear from you. How is it that you are conserving water at home? We know that South Africa is water scarce and that we've all at some point been through a drought, but this is why we want to hear. How is it that you are saving water, particularly in your house? I know for me, I take shorter showers. It was a little bit of an adjustment, but I did it because I knew that Greta Thunberg would be proud of me. So you as well, how are you doing it, my love? Let us know, hashtag Expresso Show, also with that voice note. We're getting things started. We're kicking it off in the best way possible because the weekend is in the building. But first and foremost, we got to handle business, and that is why Carl is standing by with the news headlines.
I am indeed. Thanks a lot, Zanele. And let's start nationally. Breaking news just yesterday, former Steinhoff CEO Marcus Huister has passed away at Hermanus in the Western Cape. The Financial Sector Conduct Authority, the FSCA, had imposed a 475 million rand penalty on him last week. Police confirmed the 63-year-old's death. No foul play is suspected. Colonel Andre Trout said the victim suffered a gunshot wound at around 3:20 p.m. yesterday at Kwaaiwater and succumbed en route to hospital. The FSCA investigation had found that Huister disseminated false or deceptive statements about Steinhoff, leading to the penalty. In 2017, Deloitte revealed Steinhoff's account fraud, causing enormous losses for SA investors. Now, President Cyril Ramaphosa has paid tribute to all South Africans who were part of the country's freedom struggle. He delivered the keynote address at the state's official Human Rights Day commemoration at Sharpeville in Gauteng. Yesterday morning, the president joined the families of the Sharpeville massacre of 21 March 1960 for a wreath-laying ceremony. On that day, 69 people were killed and 180 wounded when police opened fire on a group of people who were protesting against the passport laws which then existed. Now on to international news. Nigeria's president, Bola Tinubu, has imposed a three-month ban on publicly funded overseas trips by ministers and other government officials. Tinubu and his administration have come under criticism for their frequent visits abroad, while Nigerians are suffering from rising living costs and an economic crisis. From 1 April, any government official who wishes to travel abroad using public funds has first to obtain permission from the president. Much criticism was leveled when the Nigerian government reportedly paid for 422 people to attend the climate change summit in Dubai. A 62-year-old man with end-stage renal disease has become the first human to receive a new kidney from a genetically modified pig. Doctors of the Massachusetts General Hospital in Boston in the U.S. have announced. The four-hour surgery marks a major milestone in the quest to provide more readily available organs to patients, the hospital said in a statement. The patient, Richard Slayman of Weymouth, Massachusetts, is recovering well and, of course, expected to be discharged from hospital very, very soon. And wrapping up, Esther Bosov and Ruvan Grobler, camping at Kruger National Park's Sitara Rest Camp, had an unforgettable encounter last week when the lions they had been tracking all day suddenly appeared at their campsite. Esther shared their astonishment on latestsightings.com, describing their unsuccessful search for a lioness and cubs before returning to camp. While having a braai, a lion's roar broke the silence, followed by the breathtaking sight of the lioness and her cubs strolling near their tent just outside the security fence. They cautiously followed the lioness and were thrilled to also spot a male lion. Esther's initial excitement transformed into awe as the lioness growled, screaming in lowercase, something I never expected, Esther said. Truly a once-in-a-lifetime experience. They were tracking those lions all day, so it does prove that you have to be careful what you wish for. That's for news for now. Another update in 1 hour. Let's take a first look at your sport on your Feel Good Breakfast Show with G.
Thank you so much, Carl. We'll be tracking our own lions in our European rugby action a little bit later. I see Robbie and Lorenzo have stepped into studio, but right now let's give you a broader sweep and start with some footballing news. In an unexpected turn of events, Bafana Bafana battled to a 1-1 draw against Andorra in their FIFA Series International Friendly at the Annaba's 19th May 1956 stadium. Despite a significant rankings gap, Bafana sitting at 58th, they found themselves trailing to the Tricolores, 164th ranked at the moment, pretty early on in the match, needing an equaliser from Elias Mokwana. So Bafana will next face hosts Algeria in another friendly, and that's on Tuesday, the 26th of March at the Nelson Mandela Stadium in the Algiers. Then we turn to football, and a bit of a setback for Gareth Southgate and England's chances. Arsenal's Bukayo Saka has withdrawn from the squad for their upcoming friendlies against Brazil and Belgium. So Saka, a pivotal player under Gareth Southgate, undoubtedly he now sits out the Euro 2024 warm-up matches due to an undisclosed injury at this point. England faces Brazil at Wembley on Saturday and then Belgium next Tuesday, two massive tests marking their final fixtures before Southgate finalises his Euro squad in May. It's a big year for them. Then staying with footballing news, Leicester City, who are vying for a Premier League return, they face scrutiny yet again from the Premier League over possible financial rule violations spanning three seasons now. The club's championship campaign could suffer a major blow if found guilty, facing a potential points deduction and at a critical phase of this season. And additionally, the English Football League is conducting a separate financial probe as well. And then we turn to rugby. In the upcoming clash against Spain at the Pepe Rojo Stadium, our Springbok women's coach, Louis Kuhn, has included four uncapped players in the squad to put their hands up. We've got two debutants, Oliswa Kuzwayo and Anati Kolo. They'll start in the pack while Alia Chogna, Jamin and Samantha Else, they join from the bench. And then a massive milestone, captain Nolisindiso Boy is set to extend her cap record to 41 appearances. That match kicks off on Saturday at 5 p.m. I caught a sneak peek of the ladies' training. and they look immense. So we send them with all of our positive energy to go out there and conquer. And of course, we will be delving a little bit deeper into them. Gents, rugby action coming up in the URC this weekend, so stick around for that. But right now, brand new day, possibly a long weekend. Let's see if the weather's playing its part.
Well, it is playing its part, but unfortunately with a warning, the SA Weather Service has issued a yellow level 2 warning for severe thunderstorms in the eastern parts of the northwest and the southwestern bushveld of Limpopo. These storms may bring heavy downpours, light hail, damaging winds, excessive lightning, localized flooding, power surges, and life-threatening situations. Moreover, extreme hot conditions are expected in the Sara Bartman District Municipality and the Raymond Mhlaba Local Municipality of the Eastern Cape. Areas in the Namakwa interior of the Northern Cape and the Northern interior of the Western Cape face extreme high fire danger conditions, so please be safe out there. And while you are being safe, send us a sunrise view, please, 063-408-8863. We'd love to see what your sunrise looks like in your part of the world. And don't worry, you can be outside of the country. We will accept on your Feel Good Breakfast show. But let's take a look at those temperatures all over South Africa.
Upington, man, we got you, man. We got you. We're going to keep you indoors just a little bit longer and have a little bit of fun. So coming up on the show, we're going to obviously be highlighting World Water Day and what we can be doing to protect this absolutely vital resource. We'll introduce you to some of the water champions that are doing some amazing things, including Mina Joel, who is going to be running something close to an odyssey. Absolutely love it. Look at that setting. And then, of course, with that European connection in that photo, we're going to be delving into the URC, the United Rugby Championship. Robbie and Lorenzo, they've been chuckling like two little schoolgirls in the background because it's so exciting. We have got so much to get through in terms of the rugby summer, a pressure on the SA teams, and we'll delve into that. We'll take it on board after this.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back as we delve into round 12 of the United Rugby Championship. It kicks off this weekend following a well-deserved break for the teams. I think players have been pushed to the brink over the last two seasons. The Stormers aiming to overcome their recent defeat by the Bulls as they face Edinburgh here on our local turf. And meanwhile, the Sharks, eager to just show some kind of improvement on any level, they'll host Ulster, tough ask. Then the Lions hit the road to take on Connacht, while the Bulls venture to face off against the Dragons in Newport. I think that's probably the easiest draw this weekend. Here to chat to us about the weekend's action is sports podcaster Robbie Gillette, the best. I'll stop there and express our sports producer, Lorenzo Durres. Now, we already owe Tyler royalties from having said water nine times this morning, so we're going to leave it there. Gents, great to have you here. Thank you so much for being here. Interesting season from a South African perspective. You kind of get a sense that half of the South African teams were just exhausted coming into the season and just didn't have enough in the tank. And then some looking beautiful. The Bulls on a beautiful trajectory. The Stormers, somewhat confusing for us. So how do we feel about the Stormers? And obviously, they've got a home match. And an important one to win on the bounce. We need to kind of show some recovery. It looks like the team has got the potential to do something special, but it's been a bit of a weird one. How do you wrap your head around this fixture?
No, I suppose you say the team has that potential. We saw the last two seasons. It's interesting. If you look at the from 4th to 11th, there's 5 points that separate this URC, so it's open. And I think, you know, Edinburgh coming down here, they've got sort of a weakened side without the internationals, likes of Duan Funamava and those boys. So, you know, Stormers at home would want to be targeting a bonus point. Yeah. You'd like to think that that have it in them to get a bonus point against sort of a weakened Edinburgh side.
Yeah, and they want to prove a point, and there's been something special about the air in Cape Town for them lately. So we love that. The Bulls, obviously, I think probably have the easiest of the draws this weekend. All due respect, I don't know. You're shaking your head, man.
Yeah, it's away, and that's what I'm worried about, eh? You know, the Dragons could just spring something on them, but I think that the break could either be good or it could be bad, especially when you travel, and that's the thing that people don't understand, is that when you have a break and you're at home, It's a better chance for you to win. But when you have a break and then you have to travel to a different climate, you have to change your sleeping patterns, all of those things, to a certain extent.
It's not the Southern Hemisphere, man. We're just flying, just straight up. It's about an hour's difference. I suppose for the Bulls, though, they've got to be eyeing the trophy now, and they've got to be kind of looking at the bigger picture. Does that affect the way that they've been playing? Because it felt like this has been a gradual build-up to get to where they are. It hasn't been a fluke. The system is in place. They should be our kind of great hope now. Do you see any potential stumbling blocks? How are you feeling about the Dragons?
Just, I think the Bulls will be frothing at the thought of the Dragons. I don't see them.
Really?
I don't see them coming up again, coming stuck there. And I also think, so they play Leinster on the 29th. I think it's the next fixture after this. So they all want to keep within a fighting distance or puncher's chance with Leinster. So I think Jake's going to go there and he's going to target this game properly. Proper bonus point. If there's any points difference, I think kill that. They got the team to do it.
I was going to say, they found that balance of kind of inside, outside the box kind of play where young players can express themselves. Their more mature players are still running a sub 10 second 100 metres. It feels like they've got the balance. The Sharks.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, man. I know it sucks the energy out of us when we talk about a team that should have been just absolutely brimming with Springboks and hope. And have we established what hasn't worked? What has gone wrong in that Sharks camp? And how are you feeling about their prospects this weekend?
Yeah, look, the prospects is going to be a bit gloomy.
Because Ulster's tough.
Yeah, it's Ulster. You know, you've got Stephen Kitsoff that's coming back as well. So he kind of knows how these guys play, their mindset. So Eben's going to be back. But I'm not sure if it's a management concern, because you've got the player caliber. We're just not sure what's happening there at the moment. There's not really much that's come out of the Sharks camp letting us know. No insights on what could be the problem. It's not like what we saw in Sevens where people were vocal about it and they were like, we're not liking this, we're not liking that. It's a bit of a swing. Is it happening? Is it not happening? It's speculation. The guys are just not gelling individually. And as
they gave our captain away, man. They gave our captain away, and now we can't get him back.
Yeah, we could get him back. You never know with the Sharks. Rock Nations could just, you know, they could just get something in there.
What more could they buy to convince him to come back? I don't know, man.
Do you know what? I think, I'll be honest, in my vast coaching experience,
of course,
I believe that they lack an X factor. I think they've got a lot of enforcers, and the only guy that they have with sort of X factor is Grant Williams. He's not really playing.
Yeah.
So I think if you look at all the big teams at the moment, Storm has got Marnie, Damien, Bulls got Kanan and Kirtley, Lions got guys like Henku, like can break a game for you. I mean, I just think the Sharks have a lot of enforcers, you know, like the sign.
They've got a physical presence,
X-factor player like Grant Williams, breaking the line, creating that play, you know, being that link between the forwards and the backs. He can do that because he's such a dynamic player, but there's no one else. Who else do you have? You don't have a Diamani, you know, that's going to spring through and go onto the wing when you need him to get that.
For sure.
You don't have someone like Sasha Feinberg and Gorma Zulu that could get the ball and just create something on the right-hand side.
You know, someone's writing a little list now, a shopping list, based on what you say.
The ball. And that's the thing. You need someone that can come in that could just spark something that changes everything within the team, and we're not seeing that. It's just like, cool, get the ball, run. Get the ball, run. Nothing more than that.
Or maybe they'll buy a few players from the Lions who've been putting their hands up, I think, kind of bubbling under all season. And, of course, they take on Connacht as well. And I love that Lions side. They are not shy to show the brand of rugby that they want to play. And we've seen the journey that they've been on. But if you're wanting to get to see the Stormers in action against Edinburgh this weekend, we might be giving you the chance to be able to do that. We've got three sets of double tickets to give away to make it to the Cape Town Stadium. Hit us up on our social media. And we could be sending you and a mate or a few friends to go and check it out.
A Titanic battle against rugby odds, of course, and also Titanic battle against water scarcity and water availability across the world. It's World Water Day, so we connect with those making a difference on the ground, of course. A global water activist here, Mina Gulli, is here with us to make sure that we are driving a massive force behind a Run Blue campaign that you will hear all about in the next couple of seconds. And she joins us in studio just to share some insights into her upcoming run and, of course, the global movement that is for water conservation. What a privilege. And it's so nice to have you here.
Thank you very much. It's really nice to be here, particularly to be here in Cape Town, which was in many ways the genesis and the start of this whole movement that we have built around the world, and a very important place for me today to be able to celebrate, because it's literally 1 year to the day since I finished running 200 marathons. I can't even when I say it just sounds so completely ridiculous.
That's great.
For someone who neither likes running nor is very good at it. But I ran 200 marathons in 32 different countries around the world and finished on the steps of the United Nations exactly this day, 365 days ago.
Well, thank you for dropping in. Honesty, you're amazing, really. And what a great feat for you to look back at that and have an anniversary with us. This is great. But well done. We are so proud. And now we continue. We've got a campaign here, and it's an amazing campaign. It's obviously a Run Blue campaign. And what we want to do is build some idea around awareness and conservation of water. Is that the premise of this campaign?
Yeah, there's really three parts to this.
Okay.
The first one is that we want to raise awareness of the water crisis. I feel like I'm preaching to the converted every time I come back here to Cape Town, because the truth is you guys have seen the challenges that water has provided to all of us. And you've not only seen it, but you've come together to figure out ways around it and to manage it and to live through it. So the first thing for the rest of the world is understand that we have a problem. The second is to show that it's an urgent problem that we need to act on. And the third is to really drive change, because this is we can't continue in a world where we don't have enough water. We need to figure out solutions. And those solutions come from companies, from governments, and from individuals. So that's the premise of the Run Blue campaign, drive change.
All right, and change is needed. If you look at our country, you said it, you know, there are still moments of scarcity happening, and availability and safety. Water safety is also huge. So let's look at the campaign with the World Water Run. I've heard about this, and it sounds incredible. For those who have been under a bit of a rock with regard to the campaign, what is the World Water Run campaign? What's it all about?
Yeah, so one of the most special things for me finishing the campaign that I ran, the 200 marathons on the steps of the United Nations, was it was not about me running alone. What happened is that during the 200 marathons that I ran, people around the world stepped up to run alongside me. And by the time I finished, it was no longer about me running at all, thank goodness, because I hate it, as we've talked about. But it was about this global movement that we had built together.
Yes.
The biggest global grassroots movement on water in history. It is unbelievable. And the World Water Run is our opportunity to continue to build that. So it's 7 days, people across the world stepping up and running for water and showing the decision makers in the boardrooms and in the halls of power of government that we care and that we want them to act.
And it's, you know, activism is so important. That's the only way we can get awareness out there. But now we need to look forward. And now you're in Cape Town, which is very special. Are you doing any events in our vicinity? And how can anybody get up and join a cause? Because I'm hoping this is not just a one-year flash in the pan type of thing. I mean, we want to make sure that we are supporting you regularly, because if you look at water conservation, it's something that needs to be part of our lives for the rest of our lives, forever. So how do we connect with an event of yours and also just start building this narrative in our homes, communities, businesses? What do we do?
Yeah, so our ask is that everybody runs blue, whether it's a company, whether you're a government official, a policymaker, or you're just in your own homes. It's like, how do I embed water saving and water conservation measures into my own life every single day?
Yeah.
And we know, because I've been out there and I've seen it for myself, that the world has a major problem in water. At the front line of the water crisis is our rivers. I know because I've been out there and I've seen it for myself that our rivers are in distress.
Yes.
So what we want to do is to run a campaign that saves our rivers. So we are building our community around a campaign starting towards the end of the year.
Lovely.
Where I'm going to run thousands of kilometres down some of the biggest rivers in the world, including rivers right here in South Africa and in Cape Town. So for anybody that wants to participate, we have some in real life events today.
Wow.
But please, and you can go to the website to find out more. So you can go to runblue.org and you'll find out more about the runs, not only today, but the World River Run, which is the run that I'm going to do towards the end of the year. And frankly, I'm terrified
You're
by
not
because
running.
It makes... No, no. This next one makes the 200 marathons look like a warm-up.
Yeah.
So I am really terrified. But the truth is, if we want to make big change happen, we need to be prepared to do hard things. And whether it's running hundreds of marathons on the front lines of the water crisis or it's stepping up to actually solve this global problem, you know, every single one of us is capable of doing more than we realize and doing the hard things necessary to get there. So I'm excited to demonstrate that it can be done. I'm totally terrified by it, but the truth is, by being here in Cape Town, surrounded by this incredible community of people, where it all started for me, where I made the commitment here on the banks of the Orange River that this was going to be what I was going to do for the rest of my life, this inspires me. People here, this community, the strength of character, the determination, the resilience, every single time I falter, every single time I think, this is too much, this is too big, what am I doing? I'm a crazy person, I'm not even a runner. And I'm doing this like crazy, ridiculous stuff, running through flash floods, climbing up to the tops of glaciers, hanging from trees to see what the impact is of deforestation. All of those things, I remind myself of the power and strength of the people here in Cape Town and in South Africa, and I draw on it, and it's what helps me to get across the line every single day. So you guys, you inspire me.
I'm inspired. Thank you so much, Mina, and all the best with your journeys. I know you love running, but more importantly, Mina loves running water, which everybody has a right to. So World Water Day, that is your inspiration. Of course, make sure that you join whatever cause comes out of runblue.org.za. Of course, come through runblue.org. Is that correct?
Yes.
Go click on the website and connect, of course. And more water initiatives and conservation ideas for you in your Feel Good Breakfast Show right after this.
Are you auditioning and getting ready for Tropica Island of Treasure? Well, don't let joint and muscular pain hold you back. Deep Eat is your go-to warm-up solution and SA's number one choice.
Oh, yes, and here's an extra incentive. The top 7 contestants heading to the island will each receive 10,000 Rand from Deep Eat. And remember, you can upload your audition with the hashtag Deep Eat and the hashtag Tropica and tag My Tropica.
Who knows, you could be competing in Zanzibar.
Yeah, it's time to reach your full potential.
Get Deep Eat and conquer the island.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back, you beauties. Thank you so much for dialing back in as we continue to celebrate and I suppose really cast a light on World Water Day with Fritz and Maximilian Sitter, two brothers on a mission to promote water access as a basic human right. Let's just start there. They're about to embark on an insane mission, a second attempt to set a new world record by running only 60 kilometers every day for 200 consecutive days. Just let that sink in. I think I can feel the lactic acid already. The inspiring journey will not only unite people, but also support Viva Con Agua's Wash in Schools program, which is amazing, providing essential water, sanitation, and hygiene services to those who desperately need it. And trust me, in South Africa, many, many children do need that. We're also joined by Pumelela Mutali, Viva Con Agua, South Africa spokesperson, to learn a little bit more about their Nina Manzi, or Wash Bus Project, which is amazing. I try to keep the intro as long as possible, just to give you a rest, just so that you can sit here and chill. What's wrong with you guys, man? What I was joking earlier. Who lost the bet? Whose idea was this, Fritz? Because these sorts of crazy missions generally have a light bulb moment behind them. What was that light bulb moment that got you to just take this on board?
Yeah, I think there's some wires in my brain that whenever I hear about such things, I'm on it.
Like, how far can I run? How can I do that?
No, it's, and yeah, I was literally, I was doing also another challenge, a triathlon, also for fundraising. And then it was a friend of mine who told me about his idea to run from Cape Town to Cairo. And I think everyone else at that stage would have been okay, like, yeah, you do you. And I was like, okay, where, like, how do I join? How do we make this happen together? So it was me being on, I was already on a bike trip, also in Africa, cycling.
As one does, yeah.
As one does, yeah. Cycling 10,000 kilometers through southern and eastern Africa. And on this trip, it was sort of the next thing where I realized, okay, I can deal with all these challenges that such adventures bring. I sort of enjoy this physical challenge, and with that I can draw the attention, and people listen to what you say, and you can steer that attention towards topics that are important and that need the attention.
And it feels like this is universal. I've got to ask, so he's the crazy one. That begs the question, what's wrong with you, man? Because you're just, did you not look at him and go, nah, this is insane? No, obviously you had to back your bro.
Yeah.
You jumped on board. Different kind of mental prospect when you're doing something that no one's done before.
Exactly.
How do you prepare yourself for something like that, that you know, let's be honest, is going to be 90% mental?
Yeah.
The body, you can push through all sorts of things, but the brain is a different beast altogether. How are you guys kind of wrapping your head around what you got to do?
Yeah, I mean, definitely the mental aspect is bigger than it's not bigger than the physical, but it's definitely there. And you're like, you can't really prepare. That's the thing. You throw yourself in there, and you know, in our lives, we think we have control over everything. You think you have control going on Tuesday evening to sports and then on the next morning to work. And we are living this kind of thing where we think we have the control over these. And you throw yourself in these projects and really feel that you can't control it. And that's one of the biggest things in there. And mentally, you have to go through that. It's a process in the beginning. And yeah.
And you've got each other, which is going to make a massive difference, for good or for bad.
Exactly.
You've got each other right next to you. I don't know if they're going to tie each other together. But here you are on the other side of the world, raising issues in a country that so desperately needs this connection. When we talk about water being a basic human right and the mission that you and your team are on right now, you couldn't have hoped to find a better pairing, better ambassadors, better warriors to go out there and fight your cause. What is that cause? What mission are you wanting to achieve?
So first of all, I have to say they are amazing. We've found amazing collaborators in Max and Fritz. They have such a genuine heart for access to water. And I say this everywhere I go, every time I speak about them, because it's so true. So what we do at Viva Con Agua is try to bridge the gap between policy and reality. We all know that water is a basic human right enshrined in the Constitution. It's also a resolution of the United Nations. But for some reason, well, for a lot of reasons, it's just not a reality in the lives of so many people in South Africa, especially in rural areas, peri-urban areas. And we try to fill that gap one way or the other. We've got projects that deal with infrastructure. That's the Wash in Schools project that you mentioned earlier on, where we rehabilitate, maintain school infrastructure in schools in Bulungula in the Eastern Cape. And we try to empower the schools and the children themselves to do that, even beyond us being there, because we don't want it to be an initiative that depends on us or any other.
And we know how many initiatives like that fall down because you don't empower the recipients of that mechanism completely. I've got to ask you, because you're running across all sorts of terrain, but it's the people that I would imagine are going to really drive this. When you do these kinds of missions, what does it feel like when it gets real and you start to see the communities that you're helping meet the people that will ultimately benefit from the shift in baseline? What does it feel to be doing that once it's actually started and you start to see the effect of what you're doing?
I mean, the overall, besides water, the overall motto and what we're trying to communicate with this run is that actually people are great. And no matter in which circumstances you are, no matter how the communities are run, which challenges they face, I think once you get yourself out there, and we don't have a support car, there's no big walls, there's no fence, there's nothing protecting us, or there's no barriers. It's just literally a genuine human connection that is there, just because you're there on your own efforts. Like, you come there with your own tiny little legs.
Yeah, it's a spiritual passport.
Yeah, for sure. And that's, it's such a genuine connection. And to see, and also to understand, like, on eye level, okay, where are you coming from? Where am I coming from? Like, we're facing challenges, you're facing challenges, and maybe we can learn from one another and just support one another rather than being like, oh, I impose that onto you and I impose for that sure. onto you. It just opens up like a common ground from that you can work together, and having these experiences with people is just the most beautiful thing.
Yeah, man, and that validation will go so far within those communities. If you think it matters to you guys, you know, when people realize the extent that big brands are willing to go to get it right on the base level, strangers that they've never met coming from a completely different reality are willing to go to, well, let's say ridiculous lengths to prove a point, but please look after each other, look after yourselves. I know you've got an incredible brand behind you driving this in the most practical way on the ground. This is going to help, in my case, a lot of young children especially have that basic human right, and that's what we are here for. Congratulations, gents. I'll speak to you on day 150 about the mental body aspects of this particular challenge, but we're going to continue this conversation on our social so you can get all of the details on where they're going and how you can support.
Amazing stories in studio, but what about starting your amazing story? It could happen. Great things can happen today. That is if you ponder, Pusha, play Powerball for a guaranteed 98 million rand jackpot. That's a massive and life-changing jackpot. You can buy your tickets today in store on nationallottery.co.za. That's the website, the mobile app, cell phone banking, or simply by dialing *120*7529# for USSD. If you missed out on all the details, don't worry. We put them all on Expresso's social media pages, so go check them out and make sure to get yourself in the running to win the millions. A life-changing, yes, I said it, 98 million rand. Guaranteed Powerball jackpot could be yours. And it's time to make it rain lots of cash this March, so make sure you do your thing and get yourself a ticket. Also still available to you on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Of course, we have some desserts, which is lovely. You can guess those. And then we have some very, very important individuals in studio. Former Miss SA, who is an ambassador for World TB Day. We have, of course, our doctor is in the house, Tamarin Green Khumalo, who is here just to chat to you a bit more about tuberculosis. So if you need any sort of facts and figures, don't worry, we got you covered. It's your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Oh, you can make my day.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
It's Friday, baby, and this is exactly where you deserve to start off your weekend on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. And how do we do that? We make sure you are feeling good going into the day, ne? Now, of course, we know that there are big things that always lie ahead whenever Easter is around the corner. And this morning, we have got an exciting guest in studio. She is the South African Tourism Hub head, Umashutu Mokgethi, who is here to let us in on SA Tourism's Seat at the Table campaign. Now, my friend, what they're saying is we as South Africans, you, my fellow South African, we need to be inspired to go out and enjoy these beautiful experiences that await us. South Africa is a beautiful landscape of so many things that await us. But this is why we want to hear all about these experiences, which are not just affordable, but they're also accessible. And we're hearing about how we can set up our tables during Easter weekend. Everybody, please welcome Mashutu. Hello, beautiful lady.
Hello, you. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Fantastic.
I like this energy. Ah. It's giving Minister of Fun, Minister of Experiences.
Mm. Hey, it's the lashes.
Sorry about it.
The lashes are the things that are making me feel Friday-ish.
Come on, I love it. You're making me feel Friday-ish because you're here to tell us about these experiences that we can go and get on our weekend. So first and foremost, I want to hear, what is it that the beautiful Seat at the Table campaign is all about, my love?
So a couple of years ago, we realized that we need to revamp how South Africans travel for Easter. Mm-hmm. We know that usually for Easter, we all go home.
Yes.
You go and seven colors eat at home.
I was going to say, they make you work, chop.
You chop the whole day.
Yes.
And usually it's me.
Yes.
So I was very passionate about this.
Yeah.
And we thought, how do we make it something different as opposed to setting your table at home? Why don't you set it anywhere else in the country in your own way?
I love that. And especially with our friends and family, I feel like you can make home anywhere, right?
Exactly.
Yes. So then speak to us about how you're making all of these experiences more affordable and more accessible to us as South Africans.
We spend a good part of our job engaging with trade partners. Mm-hmm. So those guys who give us the beautiful experiences.
Yeah.
And we then say, guys, we're running this massive campaign.
Mm-hmm.
Come to the party with us and offer South Africans the great experiences at a decent price.
Yeah.
So that's how we are ensuring that the affordability of the experiences that people can take when they're setting their table anywhere in the country.
Come on. You see, this is why I said you're the Minister of Fun, Minister of Experiences, because you're fighting on our behalf. We all know the economy is going through a lot, but the fact that you guys are saying, no, guys, we can show you the way to affordability.
Exactly.
I love it.
Exactly.
But let's then talk about short left journeys, because, of course, there are so many different ones. What can we expect from them? You know, what do they have in common?
Road trip.
Okay.
Road trip.
Love
so,
that.
So, you know, you've got your music set up, you've got your, if you've got kids, it's Easter. I think it's the right thing to do to take your kids along.
Yeah, please don't leave them.
Yeah. Leave them kasama, not Easter.
Yes.
So you've got everything, you've got everything packed,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, you're sitting in your car, driving, you're seeing the beautiful area that South Africa is.
Yeah.
You're buying mangoes on the side of the road.
Come on.
I know, it's my favorite thing to
do.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're making me so excited right now, yes.
And by the time you actually get to wherever your destination is, you have really had a whole experience.
Yeah.
So that is what a short lift is really, really about. Experience it from the moment you pack your bag all the way to coming back,
yes.
Really, unpacking.
It's a full experience.
It's a full experience.
Yes.
Yeah.
I was telling Graham and Carl yesterday, and I was like, I'm Dora the Explorer. If there's an opportunity to go, I go. But one of the biggest reasons is because in South Africa, we have like such a vast, I think, just in choosing in terms of what there is to have when we talk about food. So speak to me about this culinary experience, because I've always said South Africans love food as much as they love sports. What is it that you guys have in store for us?
It's literally about setting your table. And we're saying, please tell us how you've set your table.
Yes.
We just came out of a whole cruise where we experienced...
I saw that, Mashutu.
Yes.
Why didn't you invite me, Mashutu? It looked so nice.
I just met you.
Okay. Okay, all right.
Next year.
Next year.
It's you and I.
I'm going to hold you to that, Mashutu. Everyone's laughing at me now, Mashutu. Yes, continue.
But that's exactly what it was. So the cruise was our way of actually showcasing the culinary experience on the cruise, which is very, very vast.
I saw.
Extremely vast. But what we will be doing is throughout the country, as I said, literally our culinary experience is the mangoes on the side of the road and the avocados. I'm from Limpopo, guys.
I can tell.
Please bear with me. So, yeah, so that's what we'll be showcasing in every communication, because we're emphasizing that you take the food somewhere else.
I love that.
Not in your house.
Come on. Yes. And of course, you guys have got your campaign Travel Wise. Speak to us about that a little bit, please.
It's quite important to make sure that when you're traveling, and I said road trips,
yes,
you are as safe as possible. We want you to come back.
Yes.
You know, you must pack and then you must unpack. We need you back.
Yeah.
So that you can take another trip.
Oh, yes.
You know?
Perfect.
So it's literally about being safe on the road. It's about spending your money wisely. Mm. It's about making sure that you are equipped with all the information that is necessary for the trip that you're taking. That's why we say travel-wise, Mzansi, please be safe on the roads this Easter.
I love that it encompasses everything.
Yeah.
And like I said, thank you to you guys for fighting for those prices for us, because it then makes it accessible to us. So shout out to you and the team, Mashutu.
Thank you.
Friends, this is for us to go out and enjoy the beautiful country that we call home, and more than anything else, to make sure that we are taking advantage of these accessible and affordable experiences thanks to Shortlift. And you can do just that just by heading over to shortlift.co.za. And make sure that you bring the friends, you bring the family, so that together you are setting up your table absolutely anywhere in South Africa in the name of Easter and the Easter weekend. There's so much more that is to come, but first and foremost, you've got to make sure you go and check out shortlift.co.za.
All right, well, if you're hungry right now, come and join our table. Come and take a seat at our table, if you will. And I suggest you play along at home, because we're about to play a super delicious game. My mouth's watering, actually, just talking about it. Guess the dessert. And I'm going to show my incredible contenders a series of mysterious desserts that are famously served with custard, and they'll need to tell me what it is. I don't know why I'm getting all emotional talking about this. As we all play, we'll be snacking along or on Clover's brand new vanilla custard. But can we first talk about the incredible human being that has stepped into our studio and has got my dear friend, you're all a fluster.
I'm fine.
Tamron Green Khumalo, former Miss SA. Welcome to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Where have you been, man? Where have you been? We've missed you, girl.
I have been living my best life.
Clearly.
Clearly. You know, all of last year, I just decided to take a sabbatical.
Brilliant.
For two reasons. One, I wanted to take a break, relax, travel a bit.
Yes.
And then also just explore other avenues outside of medicine, just to see if there's anything else that I'm also interested in. It's quite exciting. I've learned a lot about myself last year. And now I'm going back into medicine again, so.
Because we need you, girl.
Yeah.
Because we need you. We need keen minds like yours. We need purpose-driven people. But right now, we're going to set all of that aside and have a little bit of silly fun.
Okay.
His competitive eyes, the fire in the eyes have kicked in. So, Tamron, you're going to have to be honest.
I'm expecting this today.
We're going to show you a dessert.
Okay.
Or a number of them, but that are traditionally served with custard.
Okay.
And you've got to try and guess what it is. Okay.
Malva.
Let's do it. Our first picture is coming up. Yeah, I know. That was my first thing as well.
Not yet.
Exactly. Exactly. Ooh.
Really?
Do you think you know?
Are they going to show a test like that?
Yeah. Okay.
I know. Welcome to our world.
I think it's...
Back yourself. Back yourself, Tamron.
No, man, wait.
Say,
Swiss roll.
Yes. It is a Swiss roll.
It's not a team sport, eh? Let's see. If it is indeed a Swiss roll, it is. That looks like a lovely Swiss roll as well.
Because you kind of implanted into my mind.
Was that osmosis?
Yes.
Is it not a... Can we not...
You could if
act
you wanted
out.
To.
Can we not act it out? Is that not play?
Charades. We're going to play. Okay, so the next answer that you need to give me needs to be done the charades mode. Okay.
Charades mode.
I don't know if I should let you do that, actually, now that I've seen your skill set. Okay, this one looks near impossible. What is this dessert?
Okay, Carl. That's pears.
Just pears.
Mm.
You seem very confident. Is it the custard that's making you so confident?
But that's a very brown
poached pears.
Yes, that's what.
Tamron, do we give him a full point?
You eat a lot of dessert, do you?
No.
Well, actually, but on the show.
On the show, yeah.
So Tamron, he got it half of there, a full point or a half point?
Give him the point.
So we're going to put the on top of the custard for this one. All right. So a lot of love here. Let's see our next challenge. Wow.
How are you?
I don't know.
There's an apple in the back.
But that looks like apple pie to me.
Yeah,
like crumble apple pie.
I said apple.
So something with cinnamon and spice, which is a great compliment to the custard. Let's see. Come on, Carl, I back you. Apple strudel.
Oh. Okay, but then again, I said
it's a pie or strudel.
Tam is an apple, so apple.
I'm going to have to start awarding team points, okay? No,
I think you should get the point. Please, man.
All right, all right.
Strudel.
Yeah, none of us got the strudel right.
That's okay.
Let's see our next picture. Come on.
That's Malva.
There we go. You see,
she's edging ahead of you, right?
I know it because I love it.
I also love Malva.
Who doesn't? And you've got to have it with the custard.
Can I eat one?
Of course you may.
Please, it is, in fact, your obligation to eat it. Let's have a look. It's not. It's sticky toffee pudding. Isn't that like the bougie Malva?
No.
No.
We've been had.
But that shape can be Malva as well.
Yes.
It could be. But I think traditionally Malva's a bigger, squarer, maybe. I don't know. I'm just reaching for something.
One.
So there's no points there. Oh. Custard on custard. No, frozen custard. Put on custard.
That looks very strange. I feel like I saw that in Dune. Like when I watch
them.
But okay, it could actually be, I would say it could be ice cream, but that's about it.
Tamron Singh is, let's go back to the brains, trust. What do you think?
My brains is not when it comes to desserts.
Oh, we can tell the vibe, you know. Let's have a look. Ice cream.
Oh my word, am I not going to.
Back it.
I'm going to be eating ice cream and custard for the rest of this weekend, I have a feeling. I absolutely
love
it. Do we have one more to squeeze in?
One more.
Let's do it. Let's see. Come on. Come on. Please be the thing. It's got to be, I think.
Do you know what? That just looks like chocolate cake to me. That's
really?
I'm sorry. It just, looks like chocolate cake.
A little more fruity.
That's it.
Carrot cake.
It just looks like a cake of some sort. That's what I meant.
We're going to give this absolute point, absolute victory. To our Miss SA representative here. It's a fruit cake.
I can't get that.
No, look, that was tough. It was quite European in its base plate there. Okay, so I understand that we were maybe not quite as au fait, but you did brilliantly. You've almost finished your custard from trying to keep your mouth closed. We really appreciate. Tamron, you are a superstar. Thank you so much for coming to play along. Please finish that bowl.
We will.
We're going to be connecting with Tamron around a very serious topic in just a moment, but right now we are going to keep it light. And this weekend, it is your chance to go and make or buy that dessert that you've been craving or will be craving after seeing those, and then smother it in as much clover custard as you want. You can use two full tubs, and we'd love to hear from you. What is your most favorite dessert to eat with custard? And now that we know that ice cream's allowed, anything goes. Connect with us online and let us know. Tamron's in the hot seat to talk about TB, a vitally important conversation that all of us need to plug into in a moment.
Elevate your custard game with the all-new vanilla-flavored clover custard. So creamy and smooth, it makes all the other desserts a little jelly.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. All right, so, of course, Tamarin has now admitted to taking a year off to discover new things about herself. Let's see if she can do it on TV. Do you want to take us to the news?
Let's go to Carl Wastey for the news.
Brilliant.
Thank you so much. And let's take a look nationally. Let's start there. The Speaker of the National Assembly, that is Nosiviwe Mapisa-Qakula, has taken special leave from her post in view of recent developments. On Tuesday last week, her home was raided by the National Prosecuting Authority's Investigating Directorate in connection with alleged corruption during her tenure as Minister of Defence. Mapisa-Qakula expressed her willingness to comply and cooperate with the authorities. Despite maintaining her innocence following Tuesday's raid, she has decided to vacate her position. This decision means that she won't attend the 148th session of the Inter-Parliamentary Union Assembly that will be in Geneva in Switzerland. Now, former Steinhoff CEO Marcus Uister has passed away at Manus in the Western Cape. The Financial Sector Conduct Authority, the FSCA, had imposed a 475 million rand penalty on him last week. Police confirmed the 63-year-old's death. No foul play is suspected. Colonel Andre Trout said the victim suffered a gunshot wound at around 3:20 p.m. yesterday at Kwaivater and succumbed en route to hospital. The FSCA investigation had found that Uister disseminated false or deceptive statements about Steinhoff, leading to the penalty. In 2017, Deloitte revealed Steinhoff's accounting fraud, causing enormous losses for SA investors. On to international news. The United Nations General Assembly has adopted the first global resolution on artificial intelligence to encourage protecting personal data, monitoring AI for risks, and safeguarding human rights, US officials have said. The non-binding resolution proposed by the US and agreed to by 122 other countries took 3 months to negotiate and advocate strengthening privacy policies. The resolution's the latest in a series of initiatives by governments around the world to shape AI's development amid fears it could be used to disrupt democratic processes, turbocharge fraud, or lead to dramatic job losses. Now, Nigeria's President Bola Tinubu has imposed a 3-month ban on publicly funded overseas trips by ministers and other government officials. Tinubu and his administration have come under fire for their frequent visits abroad, while Nigerians are suffering from rising living costs and an economic crisis. From 1 April, any government official who wishes to travel abroad using public funds has first to obtain a permission from the president. There was much criticism leveled when the Nigerian government reportedly paid for 422 people to attend the climate change summit that was in Dubai. And wrapping up, Esther Boshoff and Ruvan Grobler camping at Kruger National Park's Satara Rest Camp had an unforgettable encounter last week where the lions they had been tracking all day suddenly appeared at their campsite. Esther shared their astonishment on latestsightings.com, describing the unsuccessful search for a lioness and cubs before returning to camp. While having a braai, a lion's roar broke the silence, followed by the breathtaking sight of the lioness and her cubs strolling near their tent just outside the security fence. They cautiously followed the lioness and were thrilled to also spot a male lion. Esther's initial excitement transformed into awe as the lioness growled, screaming in lowercase, "Something I never expected," Esther said. Truly a once-in-a-lifetime experience. And that's it for news for now. Another update in 1 hour. Let's take a look at the sport. Here's Graham.
Time to find out who are the lions and who are the lambs. Let's look at yesterday's footballing action. In an unexpected turn of events, Bafana Bafana battled it out to a 1-1 draw against Andorra in their FIFA Series International Friendly at Annaba. Today, the 26th of March at the Nelson Mandela Stadium in the Algiers, so a little further afield. Then we turn to the broader perspective on football at the moment, and in a massive setback for England, Arsenal's Bukayo Saka has withdrawn from the squad for the upcoming friendlies against Brazil and Belgium. So Saka, who is undoubtedly a pivotal player under Gareth Southgate, he sits out the Euro 2024 warm-up matches due to an undisclosed injury at this point. And they've got a pretty tough ask ahead of England. They face Brazil at Wembley on Saturday and then Belgium next Tuesday. And that, of course, marks their final fixtures before Southgate finalises his Euro squad in May. Then we turn to a story currently unfolding in football. Leicester City, vying, of course, for a Premier League return. They face scrutiny, from the Premier League, I think my voice is warming up for Dozy a little bit later. Of course, we've got the Premier League now over possible financial violations spanning three seasons, now putting massive scrutiny on them. The club's championship campaign could suffer a major blow if found guilty, facing a potential points deduction. Then additionally, the English Football League is conducting their own separate financial probe. So I think they're going to run out of room pretty quickly. Now we turn to international rugby and our girls in the upcoming clash against Spain at the Pepe Rojo Stadium. Springbok women's coach Lubi Kuhn has included four uncapped players in the squad. Two debutants, Oliswa Kuzwayo and Anati Xolo, they will start in the pack, while Aliyah Chogna Jamin and Samantha Else, they'll be joining from the bench. And then a massive milestone for captain Nolisson Diso Boy. She is set to extend her cap record to 41 appearances. That match kicking off on Saturday at 5 p.m., sending all of the positive energy we can to our girls. And that's where we leave our sport for this morning, in the midst of what is probably a long weekend for most of you. I know there is a little bit of traffic to report on. Let's get you to work if you're going there safely.
All right, so it is a long weekend, but there is still some traffic here and there. Let's start in Cape Town. There's been an accident on the N2 inbound on Bunga Avenue. The center lane is currently closed. Do expect delays, as you can see on your screen now. And then I even drove through this heavy fog and misty conditions on the way to work this morning. So please, if you are on those roads, please reduce your speed. Visibility is a bit of a struggle on the roads, so make sure that you are aware of any hazards in front of you. I would suggest slowing it down. I'd rather you be extremely careful and get to work or anywhere you're going safely this morning as we take a look at your weather. Let's start weather news with a bit of a warning. The SA Weather Service has issued a yellow level 2 warning for severe thunderstorms in the eastern parts of the northwest and the southwestern bushveld in Limpopo. These storms may bring heavy downpours, light hail, damaging winds, excessive lightning, localized flooding, power surges, and life-threatening situations. Moreover, extreme hot conditions are expected in the Sara Bartman District Municipality and the Raymond Mhlaba Local Municipality of the Eastern Cape. Areas in the Namakwa interior of the Northern Cape and the Northern interior of the Western Cape face extreme high fire danger conditions. And now for a sunrise view to put a smile on your face from Judy Joseph in Port Alfred, sharing this morning view with us. And if you look at that, that is a long weekend starter. It really is. There's something about it. You kind of feel like you should have taken leave today, but even if you didn't, it still feels relaxing. Thank you. We love those. Morning views are always accepted, so send yours. 063-408-8863. Let's take a last look at the temperatures across the country on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. You are 35, you love the heat, don't you? But either way, have a fantastic Friday today. Now, let us take a very, very important look at something that is, it's pertinent to everybody, World Tuberculosis Day. It will be observed on Sunday, the 24th of March, and it's heartbreaking to think that TB is still one of the world's deadliest diseases, with recent years showing a worrying increase in drug-resistant TB. Now, knowing this increases this urgency of awareness, of course, and who better to spread the word than a medical doctor, a TB survivor, a former Miss SA, and somebody who just cares about everybody around her. We've got the good doctor in the house, Tamarin Green Khumalo, who is here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Doctor, thank you.
It's an absolute pleasure to be here. Thank you for having me.
No problem. We filled you with sugar first so you would be ready for the interview. Clearly, we went desserts first and now we can chat about TB. And this has become a massive passion of yours. Obviously, you're a TB survivor.
Yes.
And there are so many myths that are circling around. And I would love to know, because I think that when people think about TB, they think like, it'll never happen to me. Exactly. Don't it only happen in townships?
Exactly.
Doesn't it only happen in those areas where the water is like dirty? Yeah. And it's unfortunate that that's the sentiment around me. That's what people think. And so we need to break that. But I mean, why is there such a stigma around TB?
To be honest, majority of cases we do find in the more impoverished areas.
Okay.
And that is why that stigma is related to it.
Yes.
So majority of the percentage and statistics are there.
Okay.
But like myself, I was a third-year medical student. I myself thought it would never happen to me.
Yes.
And then it did.
Okay.
And I thought, what's the perfect place and perfect thing, like opportunity for me to raise awareness is to talk about my story.
Yeah.
Because I was also in South Africa and I just felt like it can affect everyone. And you shouldn't be scared to talk about it.
Yeah.
So when it comes to the stigma, it's such an important part of having to fight that battle against TB, because people are scared of coming forward. And this has to do with fear of discrimination.
Yeah.
So a few of the myths and the stigmatizations that I can talk about, for example, is, you know, even cultural beliefs. There are certain cultural beliefs that it's associated with witchcraft, that there are certain families who are cursed. And it's generational that they all have TB.
Yeah.
But if you look at the educated side of it, of course, it spreads within families because it's in enclosed environments.
Yes.
There are also myths that it's related to HIV. And it is very closely associated with HIV. But as we all know the history, there's a lot of promiscuity associated with HIV. People think it's, you know, people behaving, uncleanliness, associated with all of that. And they also have the same symptoms and signs, loss of weight, lymphadenopathy, fevers. So people automatically think when you have TB that you also have HIV. So there's also that association. More of the stigmas around it is that you're dirty, that you, you know, you're poor, you come from a background where you're not educated. It boggles my mind that TB has been around for so long.
Yes.
And people still think this about tuberculosis. So it's very, very important for us to break those stigmas so that people are not scared and they can go forward, go for diagnostic tests, get their treatments. And that's currently what's happening. People are not going. So then they sit at home and they get more and more severely ill. And by the time they get to the treatment, it's either too late.
Yeah.
And then that cycle just feeds into itself because then they take the medication, but it doesn't help. And now people believe, oh no, the medication doesn't help. But it's because they've been sitting at home for so long, not getting the treatment.
It is intriguing because what you just said now, even in my circle, it's somebody would rather soften the idea of tuberculosis. So they'll say, ach, it's a bit of a cough, man, I'm fine. Mm. Now, and they'll go, I'm fine, I'm fine, I'm fine, until they are, now I'm feeling a bit weak today. And then it just becomes more and more of a problem. So with the awareness coming up, the awareness day specifically, how do we tell anybody who is having symptoms to say that it's okay to go and get yourself checked out? I mean, how do we actually take those people and say there's no stigma? You know, wipe that slate clean and say, if you are sick, everybody gets sick. Just focus on your own health and go get it checked out. I would love that to be a part of the awareness, but how do we get them there?
I would actually want to challenge any other survivors out there who are in positions like myself.
Yes.
To please come forward and please share your story, whether it's on social media, with the people around you. We've all experienced it, and I'm an example to say that it's okay.
Yeah.
You know, we can, and we'll make it together. Let's stand together, because one thing I also learned through TB is that no man's an island. You can't deal with it yourself.
Yeah.
You need the support of your community to fight an illness like tuberculosis.
Yes.
So I'm actually challenging people to please speak up. That's one way of us addressing it.
Yes, and we have to
step
forward.
And I know there are many.
Yes, there are. But once again, stigma stops people. And I think we all get sick. We are all human beings. And I think that once you identify, even if it's a small cough, I think just go see your general practitioner and get it sorted out.
Yeah, so the symptoms you're looking for is cough is the general one.
Yes.
But in my case, I didn't have a cough at all.
Oh my goodness.
So I was quite confused. It can be lymphadenopathy. So that's basically just enlarged lymph nodes. Loss of weight is a very, very popular one.
Yeah.
So you have to look out for that. And then it can affect any organ in your body. It's not only the lungs. That's what people also don't understand. They think that TB is always in the lungs. It can be in your liver. It can be in your heart, around your heart. So if you're just feeling unwell, please go to a doctor and get yourself checked out as soon as possible. That way you can prevent spreading the illness around to the people around you and your loved ones.
Thank you so much, Doctor. That was absolutely incredible. And I think we do need to take this very, very seriously. Sunday is an awareness day, but there should be a day every day.
Exactly. You
know, we should think about this as well, which is wonderful. Thanks a lot for doing that. It's wonderful. So TB Day coming up on Sunday. Make sure you find out more. Do the necessary. More importantly, if you are feeling ill, it's okay to be ill. It's okay not to be okay. Just go see your general practitioner and get it sorted out. It's your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. And sprinting back into your lounge, we're so excited. We just can't hide it. Why? Because Easter is 1 week away and Woolies has gone all out, all in, if you will, from the fluffiest onesie to stylish bunny-fied staples. They are making sure that our little ones are ready for every occasion. And here to hop straight into some great outfit ideas for the smallest members of the family is stylist and creative director Taryn Oppel.
Hello, Graham.
Broody alert.
Oh,
because,
no.
This is the cutest, sweetest stuff. I know you're on a particular journey yourself right now, girl.
Let's just hold it for that.
Exactly. Just tread lightly because it is amazing. The cuteness overload that we experience in Woolies, building up to any occasion, but Easter especially,
yes,
because we've got the warm, fluffy bunny element.
All over it.
It is a great way to get your little ones into the magical mood of Easter. From the what they wear when they wake up on Easter morning to do the Easter egg hunt.
I mean, how exciting.
Yes, exactly. It's
so
the
exciting.
Most exciting thing you can do. So what offering do we offer our little people? What have you got for the kids?
So, we've got such a cute array of things. I'm going to start off with the girls. One thing that Woolies does really well is a polo fleece and cozy fleece. And these are just a zip-up version. And, I mean, look how adorable the embroidery is with the bunnies.
Ridiculously cute.
It's super cute. And the colors are really great as well.
And the integrity of the fabric remains.
Absolutely.
It's almost wash-proof. There is a reason why we'll go get our staple set at Woolies because the quality lasts.
It lasts. I mean, you'll go like 3 Easter's and it's still
for sure. Well,
looking
it's
brand new.
It's hand-me-down quality stuff, you know, so I'm sorry for the little brother that has to get his sister's
jersey. Cool, and then there's also some dress options.
Oh,
I mean, all over bunny or just a little bit of a hint of a little animal. It's super cute, the corduroy with the little long sleeve tee that comes with it as a set. So that's good value
for
money.
And I love that because it's functional as well. It's going to keep them warm. It's going to make them feel absolutely amazing. But they can play in it.
They can move and do whatever they need to do. I mean, I spoke about the cozy fleece.
Oh,
this is super warm and comfortable, just really soft. And then, of course, the little logos and prints on there as well. I just want to touch on the boys.
I love the fact, because I'm a big one for allowing my daughter to choose the clothes that she wants to with mixed varying success.
It's probably always always a mix and match.
But it becomes really easy when you've got character-driven elements, stylistic elements that they buy into.
Yes.
So you're not just forcing them into a mold.
And it brings out their personality. And yeah, just having them make their own choices is really cool. But when it comes to the boys, they're like, listen, I'm going to be suave on Christmas.
On
Easter lunch, I mean.
Get out
little bow tie
of town.
And shirt.
Is that a waistcoat?
It is. I mean, it comes with the trousers, so like a three-piece suit for a little boy. Imagine.
That is
very cute.
I mean, you talk about a staple that you can dress up or down or for occasions.
Yes.
You need to have that go-to, and that is beautiful.
Absolutely. And then there's just like so many shirt options, really cute to look smart for the occasion. Chinos. Obviously, these also come are made with an adjustable waistband, so as
that
they grow.
That makes a big difference, it really does. Now they can look as cool as dad, hey?
A little twinning moment, of course.
Oh, that is super.
And then it doesn't end there because they've also got jammies.
Oh, and you need that.
And you spoke about waking up, there we go. It's super, super soft, really cute, and so fun.
Oh man, absolutely beautiful. You know, I can feel a suaveness, a suave energy coming from the other side of our studio.
Can you feel it?
Can we see some of these outfits in action?
Yes, why don't we?
All right, so Hamish, I know oh so well, and you've brought in a little family connection. Talk through what our amazing models are wearing today.
So Hamish is the one that's looking all smart for his lunch. I love it.
Thunder, yeah.
He's got his navy chinos. I love the little Chelsea boot. It's so grown up, but so cute as well.
I know, we're twinning a little bit today, man. That
there.
Is gorgeous.
And of course, we saw the little bow tie shirt moment on the hanger, but on body, it just looks adorable and really, really cool. And then Aria's wearing a little corduroy button-up skirt, little polka dots, and the poncho.
It's too much. This is going to have most adults in the room going, oh, wow, I'm like a season behind.
Yeah.
That is so adorable.
And of course, with the girl, you know, a little bit of sequin never hurt nobody. It's a little sparkly and cute, really fun. And then with her little Chanel-esque back.
I know, get out. You know what my daughter once said when she looked at herself in the mirror, she said, I look pretty and cool.
Ooh,
and that's
I like
now become
that.
Like the baseline for me, if you can achieve
that. I love that.
And Aria has certainly achieved that.
Yeah.
Absolutely beautiful. Give us a little turn there. And I love the fact that Hamish has a very particular personality type and he's living it.
No,
in
he's
his
living
stylistic
it.
Choices.
And also, did you spot the little bunnies behind Aria's boots?
Oh, man.
Aria, turn around, let them see your bunnies behind your boots. I mean,
it's just too cool. Absolutely exquisite outfits. You can see the quality, the fit. I love Easter even more now. I love the fact that we get to have a little bit of fun with our kids, but it's not just about dressing them up. They're going to enjoy wearing the clothes as much as you're going to want to watch them wearing the clothes. It's just a cuteness overload. And don't worry, be hoppy with Woolworth's new Easter range. We are adding a little extra bonus. W Rewards members get 30% off 2 kids and baby fashion, footwear and accessories. But this offer is going to go quickly. It's only available up until Sunday, the 24th of March, just around the corner. And of course, you can shop these amazing looks in store, online or on their app, where you'll get some great fashion inspo as well. And the T's and C's can be found on woolworths.co.za. And you can tear it up on the socials if you want that one-on-one plug-in. But it looks like this is going to be the best Easter possible. Let's see if we can make Taryn as broody as possible. Show her so many gorgeous little pictures of your little ones dressed like this. We are here for that.
From hoppy things to happy skin, unlocking the secrets to healthy, radiant skin is more than just a beauty regimen. It's a journey of self-care and well-being. And Zoe attended the launch event of a very much anticipated skincare brand. So let's see what it's all about.
A very wise person once said, your skin is your best accessory, so take great care of it. Highlighting the profound truth that your skin plays a crucial role in your overall well-being. It acts as a canvas, reflecting your health, and nurturing it is an essential act of self-care. Introducing Aveeno, a globally recommended brand that utilizes oat science for healthy, beautiful skin. Committed to inclusive skincare, this product addresses dry, sensitive skin conditions with clinically proven solutions. The theme for tonight's launch at Young Black Gallery is In My Skin, and it's all about uncovering secrets to nourish radiant skin. Edna, tell me more about this campaign and how it aligns with the brand's ethics.
We want to create conversations for South Africans to be aware and start talking about those bothersome skin conditions. Because the more we have conversations, the more we can be able to help each other. But most importantly for us, we want to have an educational platform where people will feel comfortable discussing those bothersome skin conditions. Aveeno is going to change that. That's why In My Skin is here.
Clinically proven to intensely hydrate for 72 hours. Enriched with triple oat complex known to boost skin ceramide levels and lock in moisture. Aveeno.
Hello everyone and welcome to Distinguished Guests, Skin Enthusiasts, to a night you are not going to forget.
We are the number one global pure-play healthcare company in the world. With the purpose to help people around the world to realize the extraordinary power of everyday care. So please, join us tonight on this journey, In My Skin, and as we do so, witness the birth of a new leader in skin health in South Africa, Aveeno. Thank you.
Aveeno!
Thank you.
Sips, I need to ask you, what does In My Skin mean to you?
It's been a journey with my skin. I'm 35 years old now, and when I was a teenager, I didn't really struggle with any skin problems. And then once I turned 30, suddenly my skin did things in the winter, it did things in the summer, and I needed to figure out a solution. So I think In My Skin is being confident in the season your skin is in at the time, and then figuring out ways to deal with that and realizing that whatever, you know, skin issue you have doesn't define you. You are beautiful, and there are solutions out there for whatever you're struggling with.
I'm excited to try the moisturizer. That's the one thing that I always struggled with, you know, like not moisturizing because I think, oh, I'm gonna be extra oily. But now that I know, I definitely wanna try the moisturizer.
I love skincare and anything to do with skincare, that is like my go-to. And Aveeno, from the products that they use, the oats, the naturals, has just drawn me to it. And I will say, I am definitely making a purchase very soon.
Today I felt seen for the first time. They spoke about eczema-prone skin, and I have eczema-prone skin. No one believes me because I take good care of it, so to have a product that's coming out, the Dermax is what I'm going for because it's gonna take care of my skin. I still smell good at the same time because of the oats extracts that are there, so there's a voice for people with dry skin.
Edna, how does Aveeno make sure that it caters to all demographics and skin types through its ranges?
Aveeno has the Daily Moisturizing range, the Skin Relief, and the Demexa range. The range is available for adults and for babies. Demexa range helps to relieve 5 common signs of eczema-prone skin.
What makes Aveeno stand out from the rest, and what are some of the benefits of using oats?
So Aveeno has the unique soothing triple oat complex. So first we have the oats extract in the product that helps to soothe your itchy skin. We have the oat oil that helps to moisturize and to also enable production of ceramides. And lastly, we have the oat flour. It helps the skin to be hydrated.
Edna, we are so excited that Aveeno is in South Africa. What can we expect from Aveeno in the future?
So you can expect Aveeno to revolutionize how people perceive
skincare in South Africa. Watch the space.
Having three little ones, and I say little, you've got a 10-year-old, a 3-year-old, and little Ellie here. You obviously have various different skin concerns within your family bubble. How do you take care of everyone's different skin needs?
So I've been quite lucky that most of my kids have had really easy skin, but my oldest has suffered with a bit of eczema over time, and so it's really important to me to use a really nourishing skincare product that is going to give them great moisture, and it's the same actually throughout. I think when you find a product that's versatile in that way, you can actually use it for all of them. So that's, yeah, it's amazing. It's really important to me.
I think the one thing impressed me is that they really care about like African skin. They understand that we're in a climate where it's really like dry and hot, so they're trying to provide something for their customers that's going to be moisturizing, long-lasting, which I enjoy.
It's been incredible seeing Aveeno arrive in South Africa, and I know it's going to make a big impact in your life. So now you have your reminder that your skin is not just a canvas or a surface, it is in fact a reflection of your well-being, so look after it.
Welcome to the skincare family, and as you can see, there is a moisturizer for everyone. Different varieties, different skin types, but more importantly, your skincare journey can officially begin now that you know that. And of course, our entertainment journey has just begun on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Very dry, tight, sensitive skin. Relieve itchy skin in just 60 seconds with Aveeno Skin Relief Moisturizing Lotion. Aveeno.
So we're going to take a momentary break, then we are back in the kitchen. It's all about those Easter festivities. Chef Clem has brought along a friend to whip up a curried leg of lamb with a creamy mushroom barley. It sounds amazing ahead of our Easter festivities. Then he is back. In fact, I think he is about to hit his peak. Dozy, the legend, is here to celebrate new music, a tour, and one of the biggest birthdays that come along, and he's here to celebrate with us this morning. Start warming up the vocal cords. We'll connect with him after this.
It's my feel good.
Welcome back. We are in the presence of royalty this morning. A musical giant, a South African giant. Dozy is in the house. Obviously a household name within the Afrikaans music scene, but his imprint on the South African musical landscape will last forever. And he is back under the brightest lights. So please, can we give this incredible human being a feel-good welcome to your feel-good breakfast show. I'm hoping your tour is going to bring you lots more applause, shouts, screams, because we need you, Guy. Welcome to our little studio. Thank you so much for being here this morning on the foot of a very big birthday.
Yeah, thank you.
I've got to ask, because it's been a minute since we've connected with you. How are you, my friend?
I've never been as well as I am now. Yeah, it's been a good journey, the music industry for me. And it took me years to realize that it's actually the responsibility of each person to look after yourself. I mean, people, they won't look after yourself like you do it.
100%.
Yeah.
Where does this come from? I've been joking that you're in the shape of your life, and it really does look like that. The energy that you're giving off is on a different level. Obviously, you've got a lot of creative juices flowing at the moment.
Yeah.
What has led to this version of Dozy? What was it, a moment, a particular person? How have you ended up at this age, on the foot of your 60th birthday, looking like you're in the shape of your life and more energy than I think we've ever seen?
You know, it's actually funny that at about 20, 30 years ago, I was in a club in Cape Town. It was a late night after all the show. We did a show and we went to a club. And there was an American guy, African-American guy, and he he was a short guy. He was a bodybuilder, you could see. And he looked at me and he said, hey, how tall are you? I said, no, I'm 202. He said, if I was your length, I would have been the world champion bodybuilder. You know, you're actually wasting your frame. And I,
wow.
And it sticked to me for so many years. And when I hit 50, I met a guy, Jacques Versace from Kaizen Wellness, and he came to me. I've got a huge gym at my house. It's like a Virgin Active.
That's how you do it, yeah.
And then I just started with Jock, and I was 140 kilos at that stage, and now I'm 95, and I'm staying at it. You know, I've been in this shape for like 10 years now, where I just almost like something bit me. I can't live without it.
Well, thank you for representing that, because I think so many people feel once you've let go of that physical self that it's gone forever. But you have proven that on a different level, that you can be your best version of yourself at any point. The same, I would imagine, applies within your musical career. You paid your dues many, many moons
ago.
Yeah,
I've been in this business since 87, you know.
Wow.
First segment of my life, I was in pubs all over South Africa. And then in 2000, I started, you know, recording and hitting the Afrikaans market and everything. And then, then I took off for 12 years, where I've got this blues bar on my property with this open air venue, Back to the Roots. A lot of people have been there.
Yeah.
And I think it was good for me, you know, because when you do music and you start, people give you all this attention. I mean, it's that fame thing, you know, and you lose yourself. And I just went out of it, and I went to rewind myself.
Just to recalibrate. Yeah. Are you different now? When you think about the creative process?
Not at all. I was just a little stoutgat when I was young. You know, like,
you finally grown up.
I didn't have any breaks. It was just, and it was also alcohol, you know. I mean,
But there was also so much momentum, inertia around you, I think, just dragging you along that line. That being said, then, when you get into studio with Nadine, when you start creating new music as you've done now, how did that feel this time round? Did it feel different? Or is it just plugging back into that well of creativity?
It is. It's been like this. I mean, I was a little small boy when I decided this is what I'm going to do for the rest of my life. I actually said to a friend of mine this morning, he said, do you ever get nervous? I said, no. When I was like 3, 4 years, 5 years old, I used to sing for the Mealylands, you know, and that was my audience. So I've never actually sang for any bigger audience than I did when
I was. I love that you're obviously celebrating your birthday, which is amazing. So I'm so glad we've got you here on the foot of that, but also a tour. So tell us a bit more about that. Where you're going to be going? Who you're going to be connecting with?
Yeah, well, I'm all over, man. I'm on my way to Kaka in Ka, where I'm also doing a thing with Zolani Maola. We're doing some stuff. Nobody's heard it before. We did it in the studio on the farm.
So now the goosebumps are coming.
Now I'm trying to get. You know, it's so good. Sport. Sport is a very good thing to unite our country. Sure. But I think we really forgot about our arts. You know, the music. I mean, I know friends of mine trying to do all these multicultural shows. And it's difficult, you know, because people are not used to it. And I just think, for me, that's all I want to do is get this country to love each other, you know.
Oh, buddy, well, you've
taken... forget about the past, you know. I mean, God gives you only today. And you're wasting your time so much to think about yesterday all the time. It's a waste of time. I mean, it's what you do of today that's going to actually take you to tomorrow and think back to yesterday and think, wow, what a day it was.
How far we've come as well. I'm going to say thank you for the voice that you've represented within the musical industry for as long as you've been here. You've been so authentically yourself, not just representing your culture, but connecting all of us through incredible music. And I think when you speak about the power of the arts, it's our ability to tell stories. And there is a whole young generation of South Africans that need to hear these stories. We're going to take you inside Dozy's story on the Insider SA. You can catch a very special expose on Monday evening. That's from 6 to 7 p.m. And then repeat Saturday, 1 p.m., Sunday, 10:30, right here on S3. You can see Dozy's birthday preparations and, of course, get to see him perform to some adoring fans, which is what he is going to do today. We've got him in the house. We have to keep him here for as long as we can. Dozy, we love you. Happy birthday ahead of time. So good to see this incredible man back doing what he loves most, and that's giving us what we demand. Dozy, so good to have you, man.
Pleasure to be here.
Dozy, you're looking great, but I need to fill you with some food today, man, because this is the season of togetherness and egg excellence and delightful Easter feasts. Here to provide us with much needed sustenance on an Easter menu is our inspiration for today. Somebody who is revered as a chef, cookbook author, food enthusiast. We have Mule Setati here from Feed My Tribe, a book that you need today. If you haven't seen it on the shelves yet, you're in the wrong shop. Go to the right shop and take it home. And then Chef Clem, thank you, you should do that. Chef Clem is here as well. What a legend he is. Holding Feed My Tribe. And I'm going to feed your tribe today. But first and foremost, Mule, welcome.
Thank you so much.
And congratulations.
Thank you.
What a book.
Book.
What a book.
What?
I'm just here. They're going to be cooking. I'm just reading.
You're just here.
Check you later.
Okay, you know what they say, the true tell of a book is that if you just turn to a page and then read a couple of lines.
First page, boom.
Right? Oh, my. Curry.
Your favorite.
Yes. Thank you.
Right. Okay, yes. So do your thing.
Okay, so yes, Mule, you're going to be cooking for us. But yes. I mean, just in terms of Easter in your home, what are we looking at? Like, what does it look like in your home?
Easter in my home is looking like lots of lamb and fish.
Ah.
So we're changing things up a bit. Can you help me with the...
I got you covered. What do you need?
With the side, we're making a lamb curry, leg of lamb.
Yes.
Making it into a curry. And then we're making a barley in like a risotto style.
Oh, yes.
For the day. So I've got some lamb going over here. I'm going to season it with some spices. And we just want to make a difference. So usually you just put the roast of lamb in the oven and have it in like a Greek style, so with some wine, with some lemon, but now we want it in a curry style.
Oh, it smells.
Which is very South African.
Very South African.
We love currying 100%. Everything.
I just want to grab one of these.
It's convenient because we're going to use some of these curry sauce. So,
talking about convenience, I am finding this new trend about people not spending ages and hours in the kitchen. And I get it. If you're feeding the tribe, you kind of want to spend time with your tribe as well.
I want to see my tribe. I want to spend time with my family. So the age of like slaving yourself away in the kitchen is
gone for
me.
Let's go catch the lamb. Let's go. No, I'm just saying. I'm just saying. How amazing that you can literally go. Oh. I spilled the cream. Oh. Okay, it's fine. Don't worry about that.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Chef Clem, hold on.
Even if hold you spilled the cream.
What is going on here?
We're not going to cry over spilled milk.
No,
that's cream.
Okay, but anyway, you know what?
It's
you know
okay. What?
Okay, we got this, So,
that's
I don't know
fine.
Why everybody behind the camera is panicking. They're like, fire extinguishers are out.
I'm not panicking.
HR ran in. What's going on? Okay. Anyway, we're talking about convenience.
Yes.
And again, so let's bring it back to the convenience. I can clean up, besides having to rearrange the whole entire kitchen, because I just spilled something.
Thank you.
The convenience is there, but all these, the chicken, the lamb, the seafood, down to the duck, the confit duck that's in store right now.
Yes.
The flavors have all been marinated into the meat because of the fact it's been vacuum sealed.
100%.
And it saves you so much time when it does come to cooking. So, love. I'm gonna start cleaning.
Please clean up for us. We'll be here.
So, just in terms of tasks around Easter, Clem, what do you think is the toughest task around
Look,
time?
Cleaning.
Show me.
I'm left-handed, right? And I'm a chef. That's the worst.
I'm also left-handed.
Are you?
No, oh my God.
So when we cook, we have to. Thank you so much, because he knows I don't know where the lappies are.
Oh, yes.
I come in, I make the mess, I leave. Thank you, Lucian. Say hello, pretty man, sir. Okay, there we go. So my role, when I do cook at home, true story, I don't feel like I've cooked until like the kitchen looks like I've cooked.
Looks like you cooked.
I look like I've cooked.
Oh, do you use like every utensil possible?
You know,
darling, you look like that when you cook.
That's what I was going to ask you.
Yes.
How do you control everything around you, plus still cook and, like, you know, just look poised, ready for camera? What is the secret?
The secret is putting love in your food. So whenever I cook, I make sure I use stuff that's ready.
Mm-hmm.
Ready
the
to cook, and it's convenient.
Yeah.
So that I can be part of the Easter egg hunt.
Bring
I'm
it.
Also a kid. I want to eat the chocolate too.
I say, okay. Because Yamurman.
I'm fine, don't worry.
You know what, we just make it. It was all planned, because I wanted to bring the tribe into the kitchen. This was all part
of
the plan.
I love how we just became four.
I know.
This is great.
I know.
We should add more. We should just bring in Dozy, Graham.
You might just have an Easter bunny.
The doctor.
Dr. Tamron Green. But okay, so when it comes, you asked this question, serious question.
No,
What is your role when it comes to Easter? Are you taking care of everything?
Yeah, so because I'm a mom, I'm literally taking care of everything. And you know how it is in families. The makoti needs to be the one that takes care of everything. So I'm like, what can I do to just make sure that I make an easy and quick recipe so that I can be part of the festivities, but still look like I made the best seven-color spread.
And you do it. This is for you. Thank you, Lucian.
So our risotto is going and stuff. So this is barley.
Yes, it's a barley risotto.
Do
we need some moisture in here, or are we going to leave it just like that?
We're going to add in some cream just to finish it off.
If we have any left.
You've got to replace.
So over here, what you're going to do is the lamb is now ready to go into the oven for 4 hours. And then you're going to add in some cinnamon sticks, which I did, some rosemary, and then you just slow roast it in the oven. So I'd love things that you can just pop into the oven at a go so that you don't slave away at the stove and your makeup doesn't melt off.
All right, absolutely.
Yes, you don't want to mess up the lashes either, because they are very well done. Just letting you know.
Definitely.
And I'm looking at that barley risotto, and that is something you could like kind of prep 80% of the way the day before and then bring it back to life on the day.
This is a whole hack.
It is a whole hack.
I've tried to make risotto. Risotto. Shoo! It is the most challenging thing to do.
Mm-hmm.
And also you have to eat it like while it's fresh. You want
to look at that.
Also it does set up, and then you make arancini. But what I like about the fact that the barley, it's not as starchy as the rice, so you'll be forgiven. That's why I say you could do 80% of the work now.
Yes.
You know what? I don't know, but I want to say yes. I feel like there's more fiber.
It is healthier, but you know.
You never know.
But who wants, when you want risotto, do you want to be like super healthy?
No.
Right?
My thing with risotto is this constant stirring.
Uh-huh.
So you're just there like stirring the whole time. But if you make it with the barley or with the grain, it's nice because it's quick. So this is 90 seconds and you're constantly stirring. Put some cream in there, and if you are lactose intolerant, coconut cream also works, or some wine and stock. Good to go.
Well, we're going to let this go.
Smells are amazing.
We've got 4 hours in that. We've got a couple of minutes in this. And Mulia, it's been amazing. Like, I'd love to chill with you for 4 hours cooking this thing, but I mean, if we can't. But what I will do is grab the book, Feed My Tribe, available at any good store. Got to be a good store, eh?
Please.
Grab yours now and feed my tribe with Mule Sitati. And remember, you can find Mule's curry leg of lamb and creamy mushroom barley recipe on expressoshow.com. Remember, you can elevate your Easter feast this year with Woolies' Easy Roast and Meals. Plus, W Rewards members are you in for a treat. Buy any two Easy Roasts and Meals, excluding frozen items. And that'll be on Saturday, the 23rd of March. Hey, what do you know? That's tomorrow. And save 25%, while all customers save 20%. This offer is only available on the 23rd of March. When is that?
Tomorrow!
Shopping at Woolworths, available in-store, online, and on the Woolies app. T's and C's do apply and can be found on woolworths.co.za. The saddest thing about this amazing recipe is that Zanele can't smell it. I wish you could, through the TV. Sure.
Yum.
I don't like this. I don't like it because, guys, every single time you're always eating food, you're always having nice things, and then you're like, Zanele, I wish. Show me. Send it through next time, guys. That's what I think, huh? Show me that you love me. Oh, my goodness. Guys, I can see you having such a delicious time. I think that it is always so beautiful that we as an Expresso family can see how we can do just that. And this is why I got to tell you what is coming up, right? So first and foremost, Dozy is going to be performing. And trust me, you want to stick around for that. And then we have got in the house two people that I am so excited about. Dr. Fizz and Dr. Anesu are getting into their travels of Africa. And it is about to be a beautiful time indeed with them. So trust me, don't go anywhere because we are about to get into it with them in a little bit, all right, after this break. That are waiting you in the weekend. Yes, every single Saturday, there's something delicious that happens on S3, but I need to tell you about the people who are here to tell us about it. So get ready to ignite your wanderlust and be transported to an absolute beautiful journey of exploring what we call home when we talk about the continent of Africa. Top Travel is back and is bringing us experiences that honestly and truly, my friend, we have not seen before, because we're being taken on this journey by two people who aren't just a power couple, but they are doctors as well. I'm talking about Dr. Fairs and Dr. Anesu, who are the new hosts of Top Travel. And we're going to be hearing from them all in the name of what is going on in this brand new season, which is, of course, brought to you by Halls, the power of menthol. And they, in fact, are the ones who are getting to refocus and refresh with Halls to make sure that they take in these experiences. So everybody, please welcome to the show, Dr. Fizz and Dr. Anesu. Is there a doctor in the house? Doctors, you know, when I wake up in the morning, my left arm, there just seems to be...
Here we go.
I know you guys get that all the time.
Yeah.
Guys, firstly, congratulations. I'm so happy for you. It's amazing. But Fez, I want to start with you because, of course, this is something brand new where this couple is taking us on this incredible adventure. It is top travel. You know, when we talk about Africa and in terms of this beautiful destination that you get to go to each and every time, and how has it been just going with your partner and having this beautiful time together?
It's been crazy.
Yes.
I think that's the word that best describes it. I've been on a number of productions before, and I've been lucky enough to host some shows, but being able to do it with her, we're both very busy. We both have packed schedules, and we've had this bucket list of things we've been wanting to do in our life, and now the opportunity came with destinations that only, honestly, are breathtaking. So it's been crazy, but it's been beautiful, and I couldn't have picked a better partner.
Couple goals, guys. Oh, my goodness. I love this. Anesu, I mean, of course, this is a new season. You guys are both doctors. What makes this new season so different, you know, especially a couple bringing us Africa?
I mean, I think we both watched those first three seasons with Jeannie and Yanez and seeing their adventures. So being able to live it and experience it ourselves is just epic on all levels.
Yeah.
I think our personalities are what will really set this season apart. You know, we're a little bit goofy. There's some playfulness in there. Mm-hmm. We also bring in some wellness. I like a little zen. Yes. So some stillness also in the mix. But generally, it's also about all of the different aspects of travel. You know, I love a little bit of lux, putting my feet up. But we also like being outside.
You love a little bit of lux?
Okay, a lot.
Thank you.
I love it.
A lot of lux, as much as we can get.
Yes.
But we also love being in the outdoors. Mm. So camping and exploring all of those different variety of experiences, I think is what's going to really make the season special.
Come on. And of course, you know, with you talking about the lux, but then also being outdoors, travel can be so unpredictable. Anything can happen at any time. So, Fizz, how would you guys deal with these things that just pop up out of nowhere?
Do you see this face?
Yes.
Like a travel show sounds great. It sounds, oh, you're on the road, you're moving around, you're doing all these things. Yeah, we definitely had moments where we were looking at each other and we're going, okay, this is wild. We don't know how we're going to get out of it.
Yeah.
It's just the two of us, but we'll figure it out, especially with the crew, because it is a moving crew. There's a lot of moving parts, but it's been fun. That's what adds that extra essence. And if you catch a couple of bags under my eyes every so often, it's because it's been some wild nights.
Of course, you know, I mean, when we talk about you guys and going to absolutely all of these different destinations, I feel like, you know, you did mention that there is the part of nice and delicious, serene, and then you got to rough it out a little bit. So how did you guys make sure that you were sort of balancing the ones who are super, super popular, but then also making sure that you're finding gems for us to explore?
Yeah, so I think Fez and I decided to put together a little bucket list, and most of the things on there are the popular hotspots, right? It's the places where you see people going and that inspire you to go there too. Mm-hmm. But those hidden gems are often things that you stumble across accidentally while trying to go to those popular places. So I really enjoy finding the little secrets. You know, nature is abundant with beautiful things that you can see.
Yes.
But it is about going with the flow, allowing the unpredictability of travel to just take you on a bit of a wild ride. And it has been the most incredible adventure, especially doing it with you.
Oh, you guys. Oh, pardon me. Oh, my goodness. Guys, is there space for someone else? You know, I mean, you said it's just you guys.
The way that our bags are,
Kaimo!
It's got a travel line.
Oh, but so...
You know, just condense.
Just condense.
Place to place. We're moving.
I'm so done with this. Fez, I'm going to come to you first. Because, of course, whenever we make television here on our television home, S3, we want people to feel a specific thing.
Yeah.
So what do you want our incredible family at home to take home from Top Travel this season?
I think we started on a beautiful premise. It's the two of us. There's a lot of love there. We want to impart wellness. We want to impart a better version of ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully when you're watching, you'll find a better version of you. But I think at the end of it, just know that everything that we said, everything that we did was authentic, and it comes from a place of just love for Africa and the world in general.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah, yeah.
And one word you want us to feel, Anesu? One word.
I think inspired is
Come
really
on.
It for me. You know, the people on a lot of our adventures are are really what I hold dear to my heart.
Yes.
So being able to see Africans, to tell their stories, it's just something that I think we haven't seen a lot of.
Mm-hmm.
And telling those stories in an authentic way, I think will inspire a lot of people to value their own life stories.
Yes.
And to go out there and learn more about the incredible people on this continent.
Beautiful. Oh, there's not just one doctor in the house, there's two. Yes, and they are taking us on a top travel, my love. It is going to be a journey and a half, and you got to make sure that you are part of it. Every single Saturday, 8:30 p.m. on S3. And with that being said, I actually want to let you in on the fact that, hey, friend, with Halls and with KLM, one of the most incredible airlines, you could possibly win yourself an incredible journey all the way to Amsterdam. And you're going to be finding out how. But like I said, it is with KLM, Royal Dutch Airlines. Watch this.
Oh, wow. Zanele, we love you, girl. Thank you for bringing us that plug in. I got a little sneak peek at some of their adventures, got an insider's view of top travel, and absolutely amazing. And there is a lot of love, chemistry. It's just incredible to see that couple doing what they love the most, and that's taking us on that journey. So thank you so much for bringing us just a little sneak peek.
I want more love.
I know,
I
man.
I love love, you know? I also love Dozy. You know, Dozy, that beautiful voice of his, and I wanted a performance. So I feel like we can demand one.
Yeah.
Umlando Kamfundisi, that's the only one that I want two maybe, if that's that's okay with you, Dozy. We will pay you in protein a little bit later, because you look so good, my friend. So here it is, live on your Feel Good Breakfast Show, it is Dozy.
Well, this is a story of an old man. I met him in the mountains of KwaZulu-Natal. For years late, and he's told me this story.
Absolutely. Absolutely beautiful.
Josie!
You passed the goosebump test about 10 times. Yeah. It's that kind of folk connection
it
to
is.
Who we are. I've been trying to put my finger on what it is that this incredible human being brings us. There is such a depth of emotion and connection to this land. Thank you, my brother. Thank you for that performance. And we're going to get some new music from Dozy in just a bit.
Indeed. Also, we have a Spring Awakening, a brand new production that'll also be your Friday dance. That's going to be very, very exciting. So we suggest you stay right there. It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show, and with the delight of Easter coming our way and the little ones needing some fun, welcome to Hopful, where all your chocolatey dreams come true. From hollow eggs to malted puff pieces and a combination of clusters to all our favorite chocolate-coated marshmallows, Woolworths has an egg-cellent selection to add to your Easter basket. Here to tell us all about what we can shop at Woolworths is our magical, exciting, and extravagant Chef Clem. Yes.
Thank you to that one person that said, woohoo, you're getting chuckles, you're getting chuckles. Thank
you. No, I paid him already, it's Graham.
All right. Oh, it's Graham. Okay, cool, Graham, you're getting chuckles. Right, let's talk about Easter. So the best part about Easter, of course, is spending time with the family.
Family.
But that one activity that everybody loves, because let's be honest, the kids start, adults take over, is the Easter egg hunt. So what do you need this year for your hunt, right?
Aww.
We're gonna obviously go up with everything chuckles. Okay, we got the slabs. Don't just do the balls, go for the slabs as well.
Yes.
Because that's quite nice. Keep the kids looking for the eggs and boom, a whole slab of chuckles. How would you feel if you found a whole slab of chuckles?
I actually wouldn't tell anybody about it.
You wouldn't?
I wouldn't even put it into my basket.
Good.
I would just
good,
take it.
Good, you're on the right the track. Room. Then yeah. We've got the crackers this year as well, and those are also a lot of fun. We've got the dark chocolate, which I know the adults love, but hey, a few kids might like some dark chocolate. Do you like dark chocolate?
Yeah.
Okay, there we
yeah.
go, there we go. Okay, we got one here.
Okay, Aria doesn't like what Hamish likes.
But then you've got, you see, my next question, you're going to answer that. So the whole full selection of chuckles is here, plus we know all the eggs and the actual goodie bags. Because you can't just have them running around. No,
yes.
Goodie bags. So I'm going to ask you,
straight.
What out of everything in front of you is your favorite? Think about it, think about it, think about it.
What do we think?
Because I know it's not the dark chocolate chuckle. Hamish, you tell me as well. Let's have a look. Let's have a quick look.
Take a peek, take a peek.
There we go, okay. Ah. Okay, you like the chuckles, you're going straight for chuckles classic. He's a classic man. You're going for the same, just a bigger bag.
Get the bigger bag.
Oh, bigger bag.
Hamish.
Hamish wants a redo, you can't do that. But before we start, I've got to ask you, what's your favorite part about Easter?
Spend time with our family.
She's like, my mom made me
say that.
Just joking, I love it, I love it. What's your favorite part about Easter?
Going on Easter.
The Easter egg hunt.
Easter egg hunt.
Okay, so it's on.
This
By the
is
way,
great,
I didn't mention these.
Oh,
we have to use these. We have to use these as a family because we forget where we put all the eggs. So what we did, we've actually gotten a whole lot of these, and these are like markers to give you an idea where the eggs are. Because
this.
It'll be a year later, and then you just, hey, Easter egg. You know, that's cool. But still, so we definitely use these. We haven't used these today. But we're going to ask you to grab a bag and just explore. And I think, how long do they have, Carl?
Well, you know, I'm gonna give you about a minute, which is 60 seconds, that's okay.
Okay.
And you know the great thing about an Easter egg hunt, you know, us adults, our Easter egg hunt is basically when you look for the rest of our salary after the debits come off. But for you, it's actually all about our Hopful amazing treats from Woolworths, which is great.
Exactly.
So are we ready?
Are you ready?
Are we excited?
Yes.
Yes, that's what I'm talking about. All right. So shall you count
up
these
shifts then?
You literally,
you
can
catch the joke.
Yeah.
No one does.
Egg.
Thank you.
There we go. You can literally go to this from this wall all the way to the drum kit on the end. Okay. And your time starts. 3, 2, just joking. Go. Now.
Go.
Wow. Okay. Immediately. Right. Immediately. Well, that's easy actually because I mean there's all right here. They can just
look
all
around.
The time.
Look, okay. All, look around. Look
I see,
everywhere.
I see one.
Okay, let me give you a hand. Let me give you a hand.
Just
yes.
Around.
Yes.
I got it.
Graham look Richards around. Is laughing on
oh,
the sideline.
I see some.
All the eggs that are not being collected.
Whoa! There's so many
go
over
there.
Here.
Go there. Go there. Go there.
Oh. And this is what usually happens. The adults take over. Whoa. In the piano. In the piano.
Nice.
Yes. Cool.
That's it.
We've never got this many Easter eggs growing up?
No, we did not. I'm gonna do live commentary. It's
ooh,
Amish coming around the outside. Aria coming through over here. Can she find more Easter
20
eggs?
Seconds
we got 20
left.
Seconds
left.
Here we go, it's happening.
Left. Don't go.
I wonder, would anybody hide Easter eggs by plants, Aria? Hey Aria, would anybody hide anything by plants? I'm just asking for a friend. I'm just asking. Aria.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Come over here.
We got a golden bunny. Okay. All right. Okay. How are we going to judge?
Wow.
Just tip all your belongings. Hamish, let's go first. Tip all your belongings in this bowl. Here we go. We got the golden bunny.
You see what I'm talking about, Chef Tim? This okay. is this is that's basically okay. debit orders. So put all your belongings in.
You know, so we got with 4, there's 7, there's 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and the golden bunny. You got 15. You got 15. Okay, we're putting it back into your bag. Thank you, Hamish.
Wow.
Okay. All right, let's see what you got. Oh, yes.
Well, that's a big egg.
What? The big, all of the big ones.
Whoa. Okay, let's go. 2, 5.
Did you also get a bit of soil there as well? That's great. Well done. You need to
9.
Dig deep.
You won't believe it.
How many?
15.
What?
What?
No way!
It literally is 15. Everybody's a winner!
Everybody's a winner!
So you can both, you both get to pick 2 extra things from the table. Amish, come around. Eric, come around that side. You get to pick 2 things.
There
I'll
we
put
go.
Everything back into your bag. So
I'm picking
this. Because yes. he learned. Okay, cool. Okay, cool.
Good idea.
Good job.
Oh, yeah, don't be shy.
Go
big
for the
one.
Yes. And one more thing.
Yes, one more.
Show everyone what you picked. Show everyone on the camera.
I gotta pick these.
Yes. Okay. Are you gonna need help? We got
the
one more thing.
Small one and the big one.
That's it. And then you another big one. That's perfect.
There we go. Look at your.
Look at this. The big one.
There we go. It's cool.
Oh.
I feel like you deserve something.
That's fine. I've been looking at this for the longest time. Oh, sorry. Take off.
There we go.
Sorry, man. I meant this.
Everyone's a winner.
Thank you.
Well done, kids. Well done,
this
Carl.
Is good. Come over here, my friends. Here we go. And a big smile here. Just the biggest smile you can, because Easter is all about the sweet things in life. W Rewards members buy any 2 chocolates on Sunday, 24 March, and save 20%. That is amazing. This offer is only available on the 24th of March. When is it available?
24th of March.
Thank you. Shop at Woolworths in-store, online, and on the Woolies app. T's and C's can be found on woolworths.co.za. Plus, you stand a chance to win a 1,000 Rand Woolies gift card. 1,000 Rand, that's a lot. Wow. Simply reply to the competition post on Expresso Facebook, X, or Instagram pages and tell us what is your ultimate chuckles treat. Could be anything. And don't forget to hashtag Woolies Easter. What's the hashtag? Woolies Easter. Say it with me.
Woolies Easter.
Yeah. Competition closes midnight Sunday, 24 March. T's and C's can be found on expressoshow.com. Happy hunting. You guys are amazing.
So we're going to leave you, but literally for a mini second. We don't want you to move a muscle. Why? Because the legend that is Dozy is back in our studio, and he's got a brand new offering just
for you, and it's, I'm told, is going to hit you right in the feels. I can feel the emotional currency rising in our studio, and then we're going to get to rock out just a little bit. There's a brand new musical that rocks, and we're going to introduce you to some of the stellar cast members in just a moment. Stick around.
Breathe for it with Halls and stand your chance of winning a trip to Amsterdam with two return economy tickets on KLM Royal Dutch Airlines and 20,000 Rand spending money. With KLM flying daily from Johannesburg and Cape Town direct to Amsterdam, from the hub of Amsterdam, KLM connects to over 150 destinations across Europe, the United Kingdom, and the USA. You could be the lucky top travel viewer to win this adventure of a lifetime by telling us how you take a moment to refresh and refocus with Halls. Comment on Top Travel's competition social posts using hashtag TopTravelTV and hashtag Halls. Breathe for it.
Get this, okay? Yeah. I'm going to drop a bomb on you right now.
Bring it.
Today's Powerball jackpot, guaranteed at a massive 98 million rand. That's almost 100 million rand.
Yo.
That is crazy. So let me give you some context around how much money this actually is. Let's fill them in.
Okay, so 98. Let me see my mathematics. Firstly, right, your lotto winnings, if I think about it, it's tax-free. Okay, this is what I've learned. Many an interviewer
you
had.
Drop the mic.
So it's tax-free, okay, which massive on its own. Secondly, right, as an example, if you had to win 98 million rand and put all that money into, let's just say, a generic savings account with an annual interest of, let me say, what, like 7%.
Okay.
You could probably live off the interest alone. After 1 year, you'd earn roughly like 6.8 million rand. So just in interest.
Just the interest.
So you'd be able to live with the interest.
And then you hand that down to your kids.
Then I'm and then your generational wealth.
Okay, so then let's factor in some compound interest over an extended period as you're building in that 6 million plus, adding it to the kitty. That is massive, but you would need the help of a professional when investing that kind of money. The sky literally is the limit. So I think it bears the question what we would do with that level of money, because that's not just life changing. We're talking about 98 million. That's changing everyone else's life around you. So maybe we can put this to Dozy,
yes,
a man whose heart and soul are invested in this country. What would you do with 98 million bucks, my brother?
I don't think we can fix the country with 98 million rand, but we can do a very good job of it to help a lot of people that are actually in such pain. And I really do think that a lot of people need that money rather than one guy having everything for himself.
I love that. Maybe keep one for yourself.
Yes.
Give 97 to invest that in the communities that you know deserve it.
But that's the thing, man. And also, you don't want the 98 million to just be flash in the pan. So if what I would do is I'd start a proper foundation and use the interest to constantly serve certain organizations who then in turn constantly serve communities. And the great thing about starting a foundation is that the money also doesn't become taxed either. So you can continue making the best amount of impact in your community as well. And that's pretty much it.
It's a foundation. A crypto academy in Khayelitsha. I like the sound of that. I like the sound of that. But I might buy a nice house.
All right,
I
would
think
you?
I might not.
What time?
I don't know. I don't think I could live that kind of level of opulence, I think I would just feel so skewed. I think Dozy hit the nail on the head here. When this baby's dying literally of starvation 2 kilometers away, how can you justify spending 4 million rand on a car? But you can do a lot with that kind of money. So maybe like a nice flat.
Yeah, well, or a housing project.
Ooh.
You're right. That'd be so good. And you can make it sustainable. So everybody that lives in a particular place will also develop and also get them jobs, make them create their own businesses as well, start a market, have them have those spots in the market, self-sustaining.
So now, you know, whoever wins this 98 million, if you don't do at least one of the things we've spoken about, shame on you, man. Shame on you. Now, there would be a bit of spoiling going on. There would definitely be a new console involved, I think, for my family. I would definitely, and I say my son loosely. but it's just beyond almost comprehension that someone is going to be 98 million rand richer. Tax-free, baby.
Now, okay, besides the whole... us making sure we impact the community. Dozy, I'd like to ask you, just with this money over here, I'm sure there are certain things that you would like to improve either on family or yourself. So I want you to dream with us, Dozy. What would you do with 98 million? Let's just say for yourself. I know you're not a selfish guy.
A bigger home gym.
You know, guys, I really promise you something. There was certain times in my life where I made a lot of money. And... I don't really think that money is here for individuals. Money is like the devil's thing, man. It can really make things happen for the world, or it can. I don't know. You know. I mean, this guy that just killed himself. I mean, it's a very good example of people that are so into themselves. You know, and just keeping everything for themselves. I really think that. We have enough money to fix our country. We don't need to win something. There's lots of money between a lot of people.
Yeah, we can do more.
That we can really fix this place.
Thank you. Love it, man. Now that we've got purpose injected into this conversation, you can start thinking about what you would do. And in fact, we put it to you guys online. What would be the first thing that you would buy if you won the incredible 98 million Powerball jackpot? And this is what you had to say.
All right, here we go. Couple of comments coming through. Go. Oh!
Ronald saying, buy a bottle or maybe a few bottles of bubbly to celebrate, then settle our debt, then bless a select few, then we are going on an amazing, well-deserved holiday before any further planning is tackled. I love that. Spread the love.
Yes.
Show your position and move from there.
Roxy, I think I would just sit in awe, take a moment just to breathe, and I catch an Uber to go buy a car.
I like the level of honesty there. Nocinto saying, I will build a skills development center for people living with disabilities in my village, then buy me a bucky for my projects. Please can someone donate a bucky to her?
Yeah, why not?
I think that is exactly what Dozy was trying to exemplify. There is a responsibility to pay it forward. But you can do a lot of forward paying with 98 million bucks.
So let's dream, but more importantly, let's act on that dream. If you want to stand a chance of winning the guaranteed 98 million rand Powerball jackpot, then you need to get your tickets and play right now.
Mm-hmm. And we've got posted on our platforms all the different ways, the multitude of ways that you can get in on the action. We can't give you the winning numbers, but maybe we'll give you some inspiration on how you can spend that money.
All right, let's have a performance from the man himself, Dozy, who is so authentic within his entire aura. We need some more music, Dozy. Take us away.
Ek het mooi gevra, gebeurel by die hemel, ek het my pa gevra, vir die been wat pas in my ribbekas, om die legkaart stikke in te las. Daar waar die gate was, my lyf het gedryf in die dooie see. Hierdie fakkels in die donker vir my aangegee, my losgemaak uit die doorndraad, toe die engel met haar hande aan die water raak. Ek het verdwaal op een spoorpaaie, jy het dit alles kom verander. Dier die breeklijn van die branders loop jy na my, een engel op die water. Hy het jou gestuur tot in die koue van my eenman vier. vas aan my vlenterjas. Jou in glas met sy waterpas. Daar waar die gate was, jy het my opgetel langs my slingervel. Met die reuse in my kop, hulle geld kom haal. Jy het my oor vertel in 'n vol verhaal. Met die bloed van jou trane, hulle terugbetaal. Ek het verdwaal op een spoorpaaie. Jy het dit alles kon verander. Met die breekpunt van die brander loop jy na my, een engel op die water. Jou gestuur tot in die koue van my eenman vuur, gemeet gepas aan my vlenterjas. Jou in glas met sy waterpas, daar waar die gate was.
Beautiful. I think I went to another universe there. Just drifted off. Absolutely amazing. Dozy, yeah. We love you, my brother. Happy early birthday for a big one coming up. And what a treat, man. What a treat.
Honestly, a Hall of Famer in my eyes, in fact. Hold it, Hall of Famer.
Yeah?
Halls.
Go there. Go
yes,
there, man.
Yes, can I go here? You know, we all have those moments where we feel overwhelmed and sometimes all that works is actually taking a step back, refreshing, refocusing, breathing.
I love that. Refresh, refocus.
Oh,
just
yeah.
Take a deep breath. So we've got a relatively fun challenge in store today, and you can play along at home if you happen to have your halls. We want some creativity and a little performance,
yeah.
And we're going to put it to the test. We will pull out three words from a hat, and we're going to need to incorporate those three words into a song.
We need a different
a
venue. We
crazy.
Can't just
yeah.
stand here.
I think we need to enter the arena. Okay.
Ooh,
look at you.
That's great. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Hey, don't stay. There's my wife.
You can have his fresh breath. Okay. So this is going to be a challenge like no other. I can feel it coming. And it's going to come right at you after the break. So I think let's maybe take a halls to refresh and refocus.
Okay,
right
you go. That's yours. Thank of course you may. Come on. This is going to be very, very good.
Right, just
that's
a big.
That. Okay, ready. Ready for
I've
it.
I've got the cherry, which I absolutely love.
Okay, I'm ready.
I have to just keep stopping myself from chewing this reed. Okay.
Pick up the words.
Okay.
Do I go on?
Mm-hmm.
I got the word. Breathe.
Okay.
That's lovely. Breathe.
Okay, can you make a song with it?
We have to make a song with breathe. Hey?
Okay.
That's okay. So, right, breathe, a song or something. Okay.
Not yet.
Next word.
Okay. Oh, you've got to take three, huh?
Mmm.
Courage.
Courage.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Breathe and courage.
Before.
And then before. So we have to make a song with before, breathe and courage. Okay, well, we're going to conjure that for a second. We'll do what we can,
refresh.
And we'll give you our improv skills once we're done with our halls and got this song locked down. Stay with us. It is your Feel Good Breakfast.
Okay, let's get the refocus. Whoa.
Shower.
You're up. It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Ah, the freshest breath welcomes you back to our studio. Thank you so much for being here. Let's give you some inspo now to just rock out. Spring Awakening is a coming-of-age rock musical. Tick my boxes already. With music by Duncan Sheik and a book and lyrics by Stephen Sater. And it comes with some gravitas. It's based on the 1891 German play Spring Awakening by Frank Werekind, which I admittedly know very little about. So I'm so glad that there is a modern update and take on this to bring us into this incredible story. And right now, I'm seated beside Anton Leighton, a director of the Leighton Alexander Musical Theatre Academy, who are doing big things. He's a producer and resident director of Spring Awakening. So let's give him an applause that matches the rock out that is about to come, my friend. I wish we could be a stadium full of people that could just respond, but we feel here.
Feels like a stadium full of people. Great.
There is a lot of good energy in this space. And you match that like for like. So thank you so much for representing what you do. Clearly, you feel the need to pour a lot back into the creative arts, which is amazing, and then create these moments. Spring Awakening. There is a story behind this production. And I love the fact that when you do something, when you lean on older material, there is compound growth in that, that every person who sings that song, every director who gets that material, that cast, it emerges as something else. Talk us through your vision.
Well, you know, the wonderful thing about it is that we didn't have to do much, actually, because as you say, since the 1900s, this piece has stood the test of time. And if you look at the title, Spring Awakening, it's all about adolescents when they start to discover the birds and the bees. And that has happened, you know, from the beginning of time. And the great thing about it is that all these themes are still relevant all these years later. And I think it's a really powerful piece for both parents and their kids to watch, because it pushes buttons, but the right ones. And it asks questions like, how much are parents actually telling their kids? How much are they discovering for themselves? What are the consequences when don't tell your kids things they need to know? So it touches on a nerve, but at the same time, it's been put together in such a beautiful kind of pop-up storybook format that I think every adolescent and their parents should see it.
I love that. It speaks up and it speaks down, which is absolutely beautiful. Within that construct, though, you've got young performers wanting to make their mark and given the perfect narrative to do that. So talk us through your version, your production. What's got you most excited?
Well, look, we're a triple threat academy, so the students have to sing and dance and act, and it's the perfect vehicle for that. But also, you know, I love it when students get to tap into things that are relevant to them.
Yes.
You know, often in a drama school or performing school, they often play roles that are much older than who they are. But in this context, it's about adolescents at the right age, played by performers of the right age, which really makes the piece zing. And what I love about it is it's bringing young talent into the theatre, you know, which are our future generations. So the material is spot on. It's about youngsters, watched by youngsters, and that really thrills me.
And I know the difference because I'm old enough to have a track record. So like Craig O'Barney, for instance,
I can
remember seeing him walk the element. So we do need to, we're going to rock out, okay, with this one. You've promised us that.
Well, it's directed by the brilliant Sylvain Strike, whose style of directing is quite unique. And I think it's a very physical style of directing. So again, when I said earlier, it's like a pop-up storybook, we have only six benches on stage. And the actors use these six benches to create different worlds. So if you can imagine, it's like a combination of gesture and a little bit of mime, but all set to a 19th century story. But then what's going on in the minds of the kids on stage actually happens in a rock format. So that's what made the show so amazing.
I love that.
Feels old school.
Yeah.
Yes. Feels old school, but then you've got this crazy rock score that combines it. So it makes it really cool.
How do we get tickets? Where are we running? I know you're going to be moving up to Monte Cassino pretty soon. So talk us through how people can plug into this. It sounds magic. I know there are a lot of young performers right now who are probably looking you up online, but they are thinking, this is what I need to plug into. So how can we do that?
Well, web tickets is the place to go to get tickets. So we run for two more weeks after this weekend at the Theatre on the Bay till the 6th of April. And then we move up to Josie to Peter Turin's Monte Cassino Theatre for 4 weeks. But it's all, web tickets will tell you everything you need to know.
I love the fact that you're doing what you're doing, and clearly you absolutely love investing in young talent. And we know that this is going to be the talent factory, my friend. When you get to take that potential and kind of bottle that and put it on a stage, that's when magical things start to happen. And we're going to get a little bit of that magic on our stage in just a moment.
All right, exciting stuff. We got some talent. We're going to pull out the hat in the next few moments. In fact, what we did actually pull out the hat, Graham and I had to do a little challenge, a random word song challenge. What it was is that in this hat were a bunch of random words. We pulled out three, and now we have to make a song with them.
Okay.
And the words that we actually pulled out was
breathe
before
courage.
And courage, which sounds like a good song, like a Celine Dion song.
Yeah.
Breathe before courage.
Hold on just a little bit longer.
Breathe.
Take that breath in. Just breathe.
Breathe before courage.
Nice.
Hey.
Let's get this right.
What are we going to do? Are we going to do like a, is it going to be a debonair type of song? Are we going to go ballad? What are we doing with the song?
We both come from the 90s and the noughties rock era. So
yeah.
I'm thinking maybe a little bit. Breathe before the courage. A bit of a rock. I wasn't
doing all
backup for
alone,
those.
You need to breathe before courage, and you'll never be alone. There we go.
So just refresh and refocus and breathe before courage.
Okay, now, and then there's a little
back?
Interlude like at that. The moment. And then it'll be, I will breathe before courage, yes I will, head of holes, have a holes, can you do the fandango, thunderbolts and lightning, very, very frightening.
Galileo.
Yeah, I needed the holes. That's the highest I've ever been, eh?
That's
in my life.
Mm. That's a Halls of Fame song. It is indeed, I had to, I went there. And you knew I was going to go there. That's right. We hope this musical interlude has provided a moment of refreshment and refocusing to start your day on the right note with Halls.
Brought to you by Halls and the power of menthol. Refresh, refocus, Halls. Breathe for it. Ungapheli umoya.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back. We got good news. So I'm still...
Yes, I know. Processing, it's okay.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. So Tropical Island of Treasure is heading to Zanzibar. Don't worry, I got you back. Zanele Patalwa will be hosting the show starring Bobby van Jaarsveld, Omohle Gela, Chad Jones is there, and Daphne Nokeri, as well as Carl Kugelman, Kobile Kwezi, and Hungani Ndlovu.
Mm-hmm. And you could be joining them. You could be heading off to Zanzibar as well. So let's take a look at some of your competition thus far. This is going to raise the stakes.
My name is Savannah Krabiak.
and I'm from the beautiful province, Northwest Harvey Square. I'm currently a freelancer and I've got a passion for the entertainment industry, such as singing, dancing, modeling and acting. The reason why I will be perfect for season 11 of Tropico, nothing is better than this amazing time to be here. I'm a treasure hunter, I'm an adventurous person, I know what I want in life, and I know I definitely want to go to an island playing with
that. Dumela, Africa Borwa. I am Bonolo Mtsukunyane, 21 years of age, and I'm from Gauteng. I believe as a model and fitness junkie, we run by the motto that says passion plus consistency equals success. And that is what I'll bring to the table on Tropica season 11. Hope you love the audition.
Action. So I'm not gonna say a lot. I feel like I should be somebody's partner because nobody's like this, right? Anyway, but yeah, we need to bring new, refreshing energy, faces, presence to national television. And I don't know, man. I believe I'm lucky. So this will prove me right if you guys pick me. You know what I mean? So yeah, shout out to all the celebs. Shout out to Tropica. Shout out to y'all, man.
You have just met your smoothest contestant yet. My name is Bakira and this is why I should be on Tropica Island of Treasure season 11.
As a physical all-rounder, I love winning and I believe I've got the mental ability to persevere through any challenge. So you best believe I've got the strength, willpower and endurance of a Tropica ninja.
Ooh, tough to beat.
Unique.
I love that. Very, very unique, representing yourself. And that was kind of the brief. We wanted you to be authentically yourselves. But here's the good news, okay? From now until the 4th of April, you stand a chance to win your share of 25,000 Rand in cash just by uploading your official Tropica Island of Treasure Zanzibar audition to social media. That's all you need to do.
That is a win-win situation. So you're applying for a dream and you could be winning at the same time. It's lovely. So if you want to do that, I want you to tag at MyTropica and include hashtag Tropica for a chance to win. Plus, you know that, a little bonus as well. The seven contestants chosen to head to Tropica Island of Treasure will also receive 10,000 Rand before even getting to Zanzibar, courtesy of DPEAT.
That's for the aching muscles.
That's just for the...
just the beat running.
Rub the 10,000 Rand on you.
Ooh, you could, eh? But please bear in mind, the clock is ticking. The official closing date for the auditions is the 5th of May. And I know it feels like it's a way to go. It's going to fly past. I promise you. And there are going to be so many entries for this. So what are you waiting for? Make your entrance a brilliant one and then get that audition video in. This is your chance to win your share. One half, in fact, of 1 million Rand. Now that is smooth, but of course the T's and C's apply.
We're in Zanzibar for Tropica Island of Treasure. Are you? Did you just swim here from South Africa? There's an easier way to find fame and your share of a smooth 1 million Rand fortune. Simply upload your audition to social media, explain why you're a match for our celebs. Add the hashtag Tropica and tag at MyTropica, and we could see you in Zanzibar. Buy a Tropica now and enter to be on the island.
Let's jump into the kitchen and enjoy Easter once again. Now, Easter is the only time of the year where it's safe to put all of your eggs in one basket. And Beacon Mellows is providing all the eggs. We are taking a trip down memory lane and revisiting some of our favorite nostalgic recipes. And one little recipe that I can't get enough of is just a little bit of Easter with some mellows and a croissant. Now, not that I grew up French, but I do like love the accent. Yeah. And that's all. So I wanted to try something with
you. Are you a Barcelona kind of guy?
I am a Barcelona.
Barcelona.
It is like
Barcelona.
That. So,
buddy, easy. This is crazy. This looks good. I bought myself one of these big value boxes yesterday. It's half done already in one day, okay?
Oh, you
and
too.
And my kids haven't even found it yet. It's all me. So I think we've proven over this kind of nostalgic journey that we've taken using our mellows. We're going to destroy the musicality of our poor singing group here in a moment. But I love the fact that we're combining the pastry, which I love, a lighter kind of croissant pastry, with this guy who can do almost anything. So create magic, my friend. What are we doing?
Right, so croissants, you know, so you can do it the old, you know, French style way, which is wonderful. You can easily do that. However, I wanted to show you a little hack.
Okay.
It's going to be a bit easier. We got our mellows, but we also have some pastry. So all you have to do, roll it out.
Okay.
Remember, if you leave this on the counter too long, it's going to dry out a bit, so you want to kind of roll with it as quick as possible, which is quite important.
Roll with
you
it.
Know. That's
roll
correct.
With it, man.
You're
roll.
Welcome. I'm here all week. All I want, you, it doesn't have to be super stunning, but just okay. Make triangles. So you want to go and do some triangles, because that is going to essentially make croissants. Think about that for a second.
Okay.
So you've got triangles over here, and we're just going to go down.
See, I would have ruined this from the first step, because I would have wanted to cut into strips, and it would have just been a failure.
But then, okay. That's the thing. So what you, and this is how easy it's going to be, and you and the kids can try this, it's fine.
All right.
But all, so you can either break it in a bit. So I would break it a bit, or I'd do the whole one. And all you're trying to do here, okay. Is you all you're doing is rolling. So you roll.
See me rolling.
Okay. You roll. And I'm remember that croissant rolling. Shape?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh my goodness, dude. Did you just make a whole croissant?
And that's it.
Oh my word.
That's all. And that's a hack. So if you want to do a croissants at home, it's an easy hack. You could do it the other more difficult way, but
look at that.
This is the way it goes. Look at that. Look, yours looks better than mine.
Well, not really. Are we like French pâtissiers? And then do we coat it with a little bit of egg once it's on here?
The reason why I love using these, okay, because South Africa's most loved marshmallows have inspired creative family fun and special moments for decades. As you can see, the versatility of mellows allows you to fry them, bake them, toast them, croissant them. Its soft, fluffy marshmallow texture adds joy and flavor. And this is the perfect indulgence for any sort of application, any occasion. More importantly, Easter, which is coming up shortly. It's great. Let's continue making a few.
I'm guessing the egg wash goes on for a bit of a crispy finish, hey?
Yes, it's okay. So there's actually a new flavor that's come up as well. I'm sure you've seen this around.
Well, I've been tasting it. I've been tasting on the sly, trying to figure out what it is. And I'm getting like heady spices.
Yes.
You know, like a spiced pumpkin pie kind of vibe, something along
so
those
that's,
lines.
That's basically where we're going
but
with it. I need some more
mellows. It's confused me so much. Have you had any...
Any ideas from my side? I'm not sure yet. I think I'm going to try my best to just... But I like the idea of the spicy, you know?
I mean,
could it be a hot cross bun flavor, who knows, but...
I was thinking like a cinnamon bun
idea.
Vibes.
Why not? Let's go for it. That's fine.
Okay.
And then before you put them on there, I'm going to... Well, you can place them on there, but we've got the egg wash as well.
Yep.
So we've got a few of these too. Let me just laminate this very quickly so I can just... Stick that down and we're good to go.
There you go. Do you want to get rid of that guy?
That's fine. Okay, cool.
Well, there we go. Thing. See what you're saying.
And then plonk them on here. We're going to do an egg wash on them so they get beautiful and golden brown. They're going to get all melty and marshmallow in the center. You're going to go into the oven for those. And you know what the great thing about this is? This is the age of the air fryer. You can stick it in the air fryer too. I'm going to go 12 to 15 minutes, keep on watching them so they don't burn, and then they are ready to serve to all of your family and friends. And remember, you can say you made a croissant Easter style on your Feel Good Breakfast show or for Easter. And also, the thing is, try and use an accent when you make them as well. These are croissants. Don't go, I made a croissant for you, mommy. No, I'm sorry. It's a croissant. And you stand a chance to win one of four sorbet vouchers valued at 1,000 rand each. Simply reply to the competition post on the Expresso Facebook, Instagram, or X pages and submit your guess of what that new flavor that Graham and I were talking about is. A little clue.
Okay.
I'm going to try to conjure.
Okay.
How about you'll find this confection nestled among the Easter spread? That's all I can say. What do you think it is? And I know, just hold it. And then include hashtag let the hunt begin in your answer. Competition closes 27 March. T's and C's can be found on expressoshow.com. Keep on making your croissants and have a beautiful Easter.
Don't make me cross, huh?
I will make
you. Don't make me hot and cross.
I feel like we need to go to Josie now.
Oh, please.
We have to go to Josie. Let's go.
Come on now. What I love about Expresso the most, I mean, look, Carl was just talking about how you can be a winner. Again, we are talking about how you can be a winner. Here, as your Expresso family, love is not just, you know, a word. It's a doing word. And this is why I want to let you in on how you can be a winner again. But I brought my beautiful friends, the power couple, Dr. Fez and Dr. Anesu, because we're talking all things top travel, brought to you by Halls. And KLM wants to take you somewhere. My doctors that are back in the house. I wanted to ask you very quickly, because, of course, you guys have gone on to just really explore Africa and bring it to us in our homes, I want to ask you, what was your favorite destination?
Oh, that's a tough one.
Yes.
For me, the Okavango Delta in Botswana.
Ooh.
I mean, I had always wanted to go there, the wildlife, you know, the vistas. So that was epic for me, getting to do that.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a tricky question. It's like trying to pick your favorite child.
People always say that there's always a favorite child, Dr. Fez. There's always.
I love Africa. I love all the destinations. But
yeah,
we do get to go back to my hometown.
Oh.
And when you go back to where you come from and see it from a different perspective, you know I got you. I love
this. Come on. And your hometown is?
South Coast, Poughkeepsie. We're around that area. And we got to do things I never got to do when I was younger. Aww. So that's going to be a highlight for me.
That's so special. And we want to give a highlight to our S3 family, right? Because you guys have a competition for us. Tell us how we can get to Amsterdam, guys, please.
Well, Amsterdam is a beautiful place, and we are top travel. We're not just going to be in Africa. We're going to be moving around all over. If you want to be part of the competition, make sure that you comment your refresh and refocus moment where you go out and you do something that you think you might not have been able to do, but then make sure that you're using hashtag Top Travel TV as well as hashtag Halls Breathe for it, and we can hopefully pick somebody who will be able to fly out there.
Absolutely. So it's all about engaging on social media. The handle is at Top Travel TV, and there'll be lots of different competition posts, so any nice comment of how you refresh and refocus, and then it's those two return economy tickets to Amsterdam. So you and a bestie, whoever it is you want to take.
And maybe a bit of
cash dollar.
A bit of spending.
Cash.
20K spending money to be exact.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I could do a 20K, guys.
Aye,
Kai. Oh, Batung. Dr. Fez. Dr. Fez doesn't want me to.
Why is he shutting you down?
Come on. You know what I mean? Guys, you need a social media manager on your travels. These top just so that they top. Think about it. Family, you heard it here from the doctors. They never lie and they know how to operate, especially because they don't just want to give you a beautiful, beautiful travel to Amsterdam, but also some little bit of cash dollar, honey. Let's check out what it is exactly that you can win with KLM.
Breathe for it with Halls and stand your chance of winning a trip to Amsterdam with two return economy tickets on KLM Royal Dutch Airlines and 20,000 Rand spending money. With KLM flying daily from Johannesburg and Cape Town direct to Amsterdam, from the hub of Amsterdam, KLM connects to over 150 destinations across Europe, the United Kingdom, and the USA. You could be the lucky top travel viewer to win this adventure of a lifetime by telling us how you take a moment to refresh and refocus with Halls. Comment on Top Travel's competition social posts using hashtag TopTravelTV and hashtag Halls. Breathe for it. T's and C's apply.
Guys, I don't like the T's and C's of my contract because I also want to enter. Hey, apparently I'm not allowed to because I work with you guys.
Exactly.
Like, I don't like this. I don't like this. That's why I said social media manager. But anyway, I will get to that. Guys, this is beautiful. So like you said, people need to upload a video and they need to, you know, do some things. Give us some tips on how we can possibly be the winners of this Amsterdam trip, guys.
Yeah, we've had lots of incredible moments with Halls on our travels. And Halls just helps you to refresh, refocus and prepare for those high octane moments. So if you comment on how you prepare yourself for that, how do you refresh, how do you get into the zone, that's a little tip that I can give you.
Come on.
And it's also not just kind of the high octane stuff, it's planning just before. So if there's something you've been really wanting to do, being a bit nervous, but you're like, you know what, I'm gonna step up and I'm gonna plan this out and then I'm gonna go do it,
yeah.
You can tell us that story. You stand a chance to find yourself on a plane to Amsterdam.
Come on, some storytelling with some refreshing and refocusing. I like it. Guys, thank you so much. Like I said, I'm sad I can't enter, but you can. So do the right thing. It is Top Travel brought to you by Halls, and you can be a winner to hopefully go on to Amsterdam with KLM. And don't forget, you need to actually watch the show, right? It's Top Travel each and every Saturday, 8:30 p.m. on S3. We're going to take a short break, but this gives you a chance to go and enter. Just start thinking about your video, ne? Don't go anywhere. You're on S3.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Let's be honest. Welcome back. Great things happen when you punt or push a play.
Oh, yeah.
And great things are going to happen when you play Powerball for a guaranteed 98 million rand jackpot today. That is massive. That is life-changing, and judging by the inspiration earlier, life-changing for everyone around you as well.
We want you to win. We really do, because we are your cousins. Don't forget about us if you do win. Anyway, you can buy your tickets today in store on the nationallottery.co.za. That's the website, mobile app, cell phone banking, or simply dial *120*7529#. That's for USSD.
If you want to go old school, and all of those details will be on our Expresso social media pages, so please go and check them out and put yourself in line to win the Mega Millions.
Oh, a
life-changing 98 million rand guaranteed in the Powerball jackpot. It could be yours. It's time to make it rain. Lots of cash. Think of the singing lessons
you
I could get with 98 million rand.
You could
rand.
Join the cast of Spring Awakening if you think about it, because they are hooking us up with the Expresso Friday musical, actually.
Yes.
Here's the details on screen, and you are still welcome to move the coffee table. Allow this local talent to take you away. It's a Spring Awakening.
Mama who bore me, Mama who gave me no way to handle things, who made me so bad. Mama, the weeping, Mama, the angels, no sleep in heaven or Bethlehem. Some pray that one day Christ will come a-calling. They light a candle and hope that it glows, and some just lie there crying for him to come and find them. But when he comes, they don't know how to go.
Goodness, thank you so much. Ladies, please, can you take yet another bow?
Wow.
Spring Awakening. Clearly, there is talent awakening on this stage. That was incredible. It was like we were listening to a recorded track. Beautiful.
No, we actually looked at each other thinking it was a recorded track. Wow, you know what? On your screen now, the details. Go support culture. It's so important. Wow.
Absolutely amazing. And we're going to say goodbye. Oh, it's been an amazing week. Thank you so much. I love you, brother. Thank
love
you for
you too,
an amazing
man.
Friday to Dozy and everyone else who joined us. This incredible cast
yes.
of Spring Awakening. Oh, we got a little musical exit from this amazing show. We'll see you on Monday. Stay safe. We love you. Mwah.
Yo, that was amazing. Yo.
Elevate your custard game with the all-new vanilla-flavored clover custard. So creamy and smooth, it makes all the other desserts a little jelly.
Another feel-good production.